This Friday Night Rivals pregame show is sponsored by Food City.
Welcome to the Friday Night Rivals pregame show. I'm PJ Johnson, and tonight we wrap up the regular season with a great matchup between South Greene and Happy Valley.
And I'm Casey Getz. Happy Valley has what every team wants at the end of the season, an opportunity for a championship. If the Warriors beat South Greene, they will get a share of the Region 1 2A title.
Absolutely. You know, we were talking to our kids about that last week. You know, anytime you can play a meaningful game at the end of the year, then you are at that point where you want to be at this point in time. So it's been a crazy year, as we know, with COVID and everything going on. So, you know, most people 5-6 weeks ago wouldn't have put us in this position to even be playing for a chance to win a co-conference championship. But these guys have worked hard. They've improved throughout the course of the year. Our coach has done a phenomenal job. And here we are with an opportunity, and that's all you can ask for.
It is hard to believe the way you started the year with the COVID mask shutting down Carter County, and now here you are with the chance, like as you said, to get a share of the title. It is kind of hard to believe in one way.
Yeah, you know, we were forced to close down for about two and a half weeks there right at the beginning of the season, pushed our season back. We lost a game against Chucky Doe, but we were able to make up the one against Cloudland. And, you know, we had a big win there in the first game of the year, but then we came out. We didn't play very well against a very good Hampton team, which you guys saw a couple weeks ago. And then we didn't play very well against a good Unicoi County team. So we kind of were on our heels a little bit for 2 weeks, and we had to get back to the drawing board and find a way to overcome those two defeats. And ever since then, we've went on a little roll. So I'm really proud of the effort our guys have shown these last 4 or 5 weeks.
They've won four in a row. Really, I think maybe the game that maybe people are going to say, wow, that was a really impressive win for you guys, was when you beat Johnson County, a bigger school who's they're in a chance to win a region championship as well. How much confidence did that win give you guys propelling yourself for the rest of the season?
Well, I felt confident going into that game in terms of our preparation. We had the best week of preparation all year. So I felt like we were going to be prepared to play. It was just a matter of being able to go out and execute it. They were just coming off a really big win over Claiborne, which at the time was undefeated. And they beat them, I think it was 40-27. So we were going to have our hands full, but our guys went up there and we faced adversity two or three times in the course of that game. And sometimes, you know, teams will fold, but our guys really showed a relentless enthusiasm and being able to play through that adversity and overcome it, got a big win up there in Mountain City. And I think it really propelled us into these last couple of weeks of practice and then a big conference game last week against North.
Your team really lives by running the ball, and Matthew Bond, he's exceptional, isn't he?
He's phenomenal, phenomenal running back. And, you know, I've told people all year, he just has a great combination of size, speed, strength, and balance. He's extremely physical runner, but he also has the elusiveness to make you miss in the open field. He's lived in the weight room. He's really started to understand the sport of football these last couple of years, and he's kind of been our featured back this year. So
you mentioned you have an opportunity ahead of you this week to win a share of a region championship, but there is a big opponent coming to your place, undefeated South Greene team that is 9-0 coming off a bye week. But as you mentioned 2 weeks ago, they played Hampton, one of the games of the year. I'm sure you're watching that game pretty closely.
We were interested in that game for sure. We were playing that night, but we were tuning in to it at halftime and at the end of the game to kind of see who won there, because that kind of helped put us in position to force a three-way tie if we can somehow find a way to win this week. So that was a big game. Obviously, I've watched that film, and you know, that was two great teams going at it. We know what we face in South Greene. Coach Jones, Coach Case, and all those guys down there do a phenomenal job coaching.
Coach, how tough is it to prepare for a player like Luke Myers who can beat you with both his arm and his legs?
I don't really know that you can fully prepare for him, you know. You know, a lot of coaches will say we need to try to stop this player or that player, and he's the type of guy, I don't know that you can really stop him. You just try to contain him. And, you know, throughout the course of the week, you really rep those defensive linemen and trying to contain him and keep him within the pocket. And then you also are having to back in, you know, your linebackers and defensive backs, making sure that they're staying in coverage on the scramble drill, because he does a really good job of extending plays, keeping his eyes downfield, and he's definitely a dual threat.
What are the two or three things you're going to tell your team all week? We must do these things to have a chance to win on Friday night.
Well, we got to be the most physical football team out there. And I think that's at every level that you play. We got to be extremely physical. We have to have ball security. first and foremost on the offense side of the ball. We got to be able to capitalize on our drives, put points on the board, but secure the football. We cannot turn the football over to a good football team. And we also got to try to force at least 2 to 3 turnovers. We call them biscuits up here on Warrior Hill. So we're really trying to force a couple of biscuits and earn a couple of those. We feel like when we do that, statistically speaking, it gives us a great chance to be successful.
Coach, we've had great success televising the last couple of games in your district because it turned out to be very exciting. How do you think your kids will react to being on television for the first time?
Well, I can't deny the fact I'm just a little worried. We actually had a little throwing session up here yesterday afternoon with our skill guys, offensive, defensive, special throwing session. So that was one of the things I already talked about. I said, you can't be looking around all over the field trying to see if you're on camera or not. You're going to be on camera. You might as well be doing the correct thing when you get there. So, you know, I do worry about that a little bit. But, you know, ever since we've taken over here 6 years ago, we've played in some big football games. This is no different to some of the others that we've been in. You know, we pride ourselves in trying to play the game the right way. So, you know, I think our guys are going to have their heads screwed on the right way. And I think we're going to play with a lot of heart and intensity. Now, is that going to, you know, take us to a big W? I don't know. It's just we have to win the one-on-one battles on Friday night. But I think our guys will be focused. If they're not, I'll be extremely disappointed.
Straight ahead, we'll catch up with South Greene head coach Sean Jones as his Rebels try to wrap up a perfect 10-0 regular season.
Drive a 2020 Subaru Crosstrek or Outback, your choice, $249 a month. Or buy with 0% for 63 months. The Tri-City's largest Subaru selection and low, low prices. Now more than ever, shop safe and save big. Number one Wallace Subaru. Right on the corner, right on the price.
Continuing education of the latest dental techniques and the investments in technologies, including the XNAV computer-guided surgical implant placement science, make the Center for Family and Implant Dentistry the clear choice to improve your smile. 24/7 at planningsmiles.dental.
Hey, Culligan. Got a water pitcher for the fam. Pretty safe, huh?
Well, basic water pitchers are passable, whereas a Culligan reverse osmosis system can reduce lead, arsenic, pesticide runoff.
Not going fast enough. Just done with that.
For 85 years, Citizens Bank has focused on you, the local people and businesses in the communities we serve. Locally owned, the bank makes decisions here, not in Nashville, New York, or Atlanta. We support our communities. Citizens Bank Stadium is one of the many projects we're proud of, in person or online at citizensbank24.com.
At Citizens Bank, supporting our neighbors and businesses and their successes is a priority, and it will continue to be a priority in the future.
Here's to 85 more years helping you with your financial needs.
Friendship Ford is your Ford truck headquarters. Drive a new Escape for $199 a month or get up to $15,000 off new F-150. All with an any reason 3-day exchange, a free lifetime warranty, and a $5,000 best price guarantee. Nobody beats Friendship Ford of Bristol. We're dealing.
New phone?
Yep. I got a new one when I switched over to Spectrum Mobile. They're faster overall and more reliable.
They all say that. It's just jibber jabber.
Jibber jabber?
Yeah, you know, balderdash.
Hooey.
What?
Did he sense any flapdoodle?
What is flapdoodle?
I think it's like hemming and hawing.
With a little bit of hogwash.
No, they're just faster and more reliable.
Okie dokie. No flim flam.
Spectrum Mobile gives you the fastest overall speeds and the most reliable service coast to coast. It's a better way to mobile. Spectrum Mobile.
Welcome back to the Friday Night Rivals pregame show brought to you by Food City. Only two teams in Northeast Tennessee are still undefeated. One is Elizabeth and the other is South Greene.
2 weeks ago, the Rebels rallied past Hampton to remain undefeated. And since they were off last week, they got to enjoy that Hampton win a little longer than usual.
The guys were excited, but, you know, we celebrated, you know, pretty much through the weekend. Then we started thinking about Happy Valley. So, but it was a big win for everybody involved in the program here at South Greene.
Coach, after we broadcast that game, I went home and watched the replay that night because I'm not sure how you won that game. It was incredible.
Yeah, you know, we looked. I think it was like 3 minutes going to game, and we still down 10. So I'm like, you know, how do we even come back? And I guess the biggest stat was if you look at time of possession, we had the ball 13 minutes that night. You know, so it was a huge deal. You know, I think a lot of people thought when we fumbled there on the one going in that we were done. But you know, I didn't feel that way. I felt like we got to stop right there. That we could score pretty quickly.
So could you have drawn up a better time to have your bye week than after that game, just kind of let everybody catch their breath, get the emotions back down before you refocus on your final game?
No, it was big. We come in last Monday, and We was trying to run a little bit to stay in shape, and most of the guys, you know, were kind of jogging. I was like, what's the deal? And they said, Coach, we're still sore. So that was a big deal, how physical it was. So, yeah, last week was really good for us to physically to get better, and, of course, mentally to, you know, calm down after all that stuff. And then, of course, by Tuesday, we started talking about Happy Valley. So that's a big deal because, you know, it's going to be a big deal around here to go 10-0. We're going to do it one other time in school history, outright conference championship 2001. So we've got a couple goals we want to finish off there next week at Happy Valley.
Coach, you're going up against maybe the district's top back in Matthew Bond. What does he bring to the
table? He's just real elusive. You know, once you hit him, you got to bring him down. You know, we saw a couple films where some people was hitting the first time and not brought him down. So we got to wrap him up. You know, he's a real explosive back, and you are correct, probably the best running back we've got in the conference. So we got to put all our eggs in his basket to stop him. And you know, they can throw the football. So, you know, we want to make them throw it, though, because we got to stop Bond. And once we do that, then hopefully our secondary can play well if they start throwing the football.
Coach, you touched on it a little bit, but what is your message to the team about the opportunity ahead of them? You know, you already have the number one seed wrapped up, but as you mentioned, to go 10-0 and get an outright region championship, what is your message to the team to keep their eye on the prize and not look ahead to the playoffs?
Well, you know, the big deal, having that zero at the end of the 10-0 is you know, a whole lot better looking than 9-1. And we know Happy Valley's dangerous. You know, you look at them in Hampton, it was 7-0, seven minutes to go in the game. So we know what Happy Valley brings to the table. Very dangerous ball club. And 2 years ago, it was coming off a big win at Hampton, and we went up there and laid an egg. So we don't want to do that this year.
Coach, can you say enough about Luke Myers? I mean, here's a kid on really the most drastic circumstances, able to bring you back against Hampton, doing it with both his arm and his leg.
You know, that's one thing about it. You know, Luke has all the numbers and all the praise, but the people he's got around him is special also. You know, Luke will be the first one to tell you, although he gets all the accolades, it's a team effort around here. And he's real humble about that, and so the rest of the guys, you know. But he does make us go. You know, you got to have one on the field and doing different things. And like I said, you know, when he fumbled there at the end of the game, had his head down, first time ever with his head down. But, you know, I just knew if we got the ball back that, you know, you want one on your side. You know, four was great for Hampton. You know, it was a duel. But I'll take number one anytime that we're in that situation where you got to score quick to win the ball game.
I know that television coverage was special for you, Coach, but we were also amazed by the internet numbers on Facebook, all the folks that tuned in to watch that game. What kind of community reaction did you get after that win?
Oh, it was huge. You know, I was getting texts the next day from people up in Virginia and other places that got to watch it. You know, we got one of my old basketball coach when I was in high school. I coached with him 1 year before he left. Chris Bunch is out in St. Louis. You know, he got to watch it. So it was big. You know, a lot of people out of Greene County that I got texts from and messages from that, you know, got to see it, you know, and y'all done a wonderful job with it. You know, it was, you know, some of, you know, kids were kind of enamored with the way you done it, kind of like on Saturday. So these kids that don't make it to Saturday, this is really cool.
Coming up, we're going to go inside the numbers on Happy Valley and South Greene as the Friday Night Rivals pregame show rolls on.
It's Jeep Adventure Days at Friendship Jeep. New Jeeps starting at $15,900 or 0% for 84 months. You can own, not lease, a new Jeep for zero down, $199 a month. Nobody beats Friendship Jeep of Bristol. We're dealing.
Welcome to the big leagues, where our go-kart all-stars take personal shopping to the next level. They always bring their A-game, so you get groceries carefully selected specifically for you. These are passionate professionals, ensuring every fruit and vegetable, every cut of meat is exactly the way you like it. This is plump. That is juicy. And this is lean. Order go-kart curbside pickup online for personal shopping at the highest level.
Why buy your new Lexus from Lexus of Kingsport?
It all starts with the highest quality luxury vehicles.
Our commitment is to provide you with the best possible buying and ownership experience.
Come check out the RX350, one of our top selling models.
Find your new Lexus at lexusofkingsport.com.
Tennessee, how can I help you?
Hey, you're still open.
Yes, we are here Monday through Saturday, 7 a.m. to 7 p.m.
That is really convenient.
With Drive-Thru Plus, our interactive teller machines, you have access to traditional banking services during non-traditional times, all from your car. Bank of Tennessee and Carter County Bank. Solutions made simple.
1, 2, 3, up! My baby don't mess around because she loves me so, and this I know for sure. Come on.
During the Today's the Day event, lease this 2020 Camry LE for $199 a month, or get the last of the 2020 Camrys with 0 for 60 financing, or get up to $3,000 customer cash. Toyota, let's go places.
Welcome back to the Friday Night Rivals pregame show brought to you by Food City. It's time to go inside the numbers on tonight's matchup between South Greene and Happy Valley.
Yeah, PJ, South Greene won this game last year, but prior to that, this series had been dominated by Happy Valley. The Warriors had won 7 in a row against South Greene before losing last year. South Greene, of course, they are chasing perfection tonight, looking to go undefeated in the regular season for just the second time ever. If Happy Valley wins, they would earn a share of the region title.
Up next, the Prep Picks crew makes their predictions for the biggest games of the week. And this week, there is a special guest picker.
I'm Steve Smith with Food City. It's great to partner with WCYB to sponsor the Friday Night Rivals pregame show. Football is so important to our communities as families gather to root on their home team, whether they're watching the game in person or on TV. And we're excited to be a sponsor. And don't forget, Food City is your tailgating headquarters.
It's a Sleep Solutions Spooktacular event. This Friday and Saturday only, save 25% on all Nectar mattresses, including the 2021 models. We got plenty in stock, so bring the truck and take it with you today.
Sleep Solutions Mattress Gallery, your solution to a great night's sleep.
It's never been a better time to buy at Friendship Hyundai. New 2022 Sun for only $169 a month, or 0% for 72 months on all 2020 Santa Fe, Sonata, and Tucson. Nobody beats Friendship Hyundai of Bristol and Johnson City. We're dealing.
For 85 years, Citizens Bank has focused on you, the local people and businesses in the communities we serve. Locally owned, the bank makes decisions here, not in Nashville, New York, or Atlanta. We support our communities. Citizens Bank Stadium is one of the many projects we're proud of. In person or online at citizensbank24.com.
At Citizens Bank, supporting our neighbors and businesses and their successes is a priority, and it will continue to be a priority in the future.
Here's to 85 more years helping you with your financial needs.
The wonder is calling. Rising sun and falling water. The moment cherished, a memory captured. Treasure found, breath taken. The look back and the view from above. The sweet taste, the craftsman's touch. The friend remembered and the sounds of coming home. Gatlinburg, the mountains are calling. Register to win a free getaway at gatlinburg.com. Please visit responsibly.
Friendship Ford is your Ford truck headquarters. Drive a new Escape for $199 a month or get up to $15,000 off new F-150, all with an Any Reason 3-Day Exchange, a free lifetime warranty, and a $5,000 best price guarantee. Nobody beats Friendship Ford of Bristol. We're dealing.
It's a Sleep Solutions Spooktacular event. This Friday and Saturday only, save 25% on all Nectar mattresses, including the 2021 models. We got plenty in stock, so bring the truck and take it with you today.
Sleep Solutions Mattress Gallery, your solution to a great night's sleep.
Welcome into Week 11 of Prep Picks. I'm Casey Getz alongside Heather Williams and Steve Wilmoth of ESPN Tri-Cities, tricitysports.com. Last week, Heather won with a 3-2 record, so congratulations, Heather. This was a first for me on Prep Picks, though, a goose egg in the win column. So Steve, now 2 games clear of me for the lead. Heather is 2 games behind me. And because of my horrendous performance last week, guys, I hired an outside consultant to make my picks for me this week. This is Riley. She just turned 1 year old last week, and she is the daughter of our very own Kristen Kwan. So Riley's making my picks this week. Heather, you get the first pick this week. First up, David Crockett at Morristown East.
First of all, welcome to having another female on the Pick'em column. We'll see if we can make it 2-0 for the girls in Prep Picks. As for the game this week, I like Crockett. I mean, they've already wrapped up a title, a championship, and I don't care that this game's on the road. They're playing some really good football right now.
Yeah, you know, I go 2-3 last week. That's a rancid performance in itself and still pick up two games in the column. And you go out and get Riley the Ringer to come in and try to make a two-game comeback. Crockett at Morristown East. No, Crockett's already won the region. They are the number one seed. Morristown East still mathematically alive for a 3 seed out of the region, but they need a huge upset from Cherokee of Daniel Boone. So what is there, you know, on the surface, what is there to play for if you're the Pioneers? Well, you want to keep playing well. You want to go in the playoffs on a strong note. I think if they go in there and they play their full allotment, the Pioneers win this one pretty handily.
Now, we were going to pick West Greene and Chucky Doak, but that game was canceled right before our taping, and Riley had already made her picks, and she picked that game, but she did pick Chucky Doak to win, and technically they did get the win because they get a COVID win, so they're in the playoffs already, but now they get a win, so we're going to give Riley that win. She also did say in terms of this game, we don't have a picture, though, but she does like Prince Collie, so we're taking David Crockett. Next up, Steve, is Johnson County at Unicoi County.
Yeah, because of that Chucky Doak COVID win, and the fact that Claiborne has a, you know, they're going to be very heavily favored against North Greene. This game has kind of become the avoid Alcoa Bowl, as it looks like the loser will be the 4 seed out of Region 1 3A. I'm going to take the Longhorns on the road, doing a little scoreboard watching, if you will.
I'm actually going to take Unicoi County. Watching that game on Friday, they really should have been in the game more than they were. I just think at home, with so much on the line, like you said, they really need to win to avoid Alcoa in the opening round. So I'm going to go with the Blue Devils.
All right, Riley made her pick on this game. She's taking Unicoi County, so Riley and I are riding with the Blue Devils at home. Heather, our Friday Night Rivals TV game, South Greene at Happy Valley. Who do you like in this one?
Well, I mean, this is a huge game for Happy Valley. If they can get a win, they could force a 3-way tie for the region championship. They're playing a lot better than they were earlier in the season. They've really gotten themselves into this regional matchup, but South Greene is just playing way too well. They're clearly the class of that conference or that region.
Yes, exactly. Happy Valley can force a 3-way tie, but because of the tiebreaker, they can't move up any in the playoff seedings. They're going to be 3. South Greene with 9 wins would still be 1. If you're the Rebels, you got a chance to join Elizabethan as the only 2 teams in the area to finish the regular season unbeaten. Rebels are just playing too well. I'm going to take South Greene in this one as well.
Riley, she's smelling the upset on Friday night. She's picking Happy Valley, so we are going to ride with the Warriors to pull off the upset at home. Riley, great pick. Let's go Happy Valley. Finally, Heather, plenty on the line for Science Hill at Bearden. Who do you like in this one?
Every time I pick against Science Hill, they've won, so Hilltopper fans may hate me for this, but I'm actually going to pick them this week.
Yeah, Science Hill been in this position 3 of the last 4 years now. 3 years ago, Jefferson County kept the Toppers from being the number one seed in the region. Last year, Bearden did the trick. This is by far not a gimme for the Toppers. This is going to be a tough trip to Bearden. I just can't see Science Hill letting this thing slip away for the 3rd time in 4 years. I'm going to take Science Hill on this one as well.
All right, Riley saw last year Bearden win in Johnson City. She says, why can't they do it at home? She is taking Bearden, so Riley and I taking Bearden. Hope everybody enjoyed this week's special edition of Prep Picks. Enjoy the games, and you can see all your scores and highlights coming up on Friday Night Huddle.
Drive a 2020 Subaru Crosstrek or Outback, your choice, $249 a month. Or buy with 0% for 63 months. The Tri-City's largest Subaru selection and low, low prices. Now more than ever, shop safe and save big. Number one Wallace Subaru. Right on the corner, right on the price.
Welcome to the big leagues, where our go-kart all-stars take personal shopping to the next level. They always bring their A-game, so you get groceries carefully selected specifically for you. These are passionate professionals, ensuring every fruit and vegetable, every cut of meat is exactly the way you like it. This is plump. That is juicy. And this is lean. Order go-kart curbside pickup online for personal shopping at the highest level.
During the Today's the Day event, get any remaining new 2020 RAV4 gas model with $1,750 customer cash or 0 for 60 financing. Or lease a RAV4 LE for just $189 a month. Toyota, let's go places.
Why buy your new Lexus from Lexus of Kingsport?
It all starts with the highest quality luxury vehicles.
Our commitment is to provide you with the best possible buying and ownership experience.
Drive a new ES350 for only $359 a month.
Find your new Lexus at LexusofKingsport.com.
Don't look good.
Yeah, it looks like it's both. Just what I don't need.
This is what you do need.
Complete the application within minutes, and if approved, you may get the money you need as soon as the same business day. Get the cash you need fast. Apply online today. Go to CashNetUSA.com.
It's Ram Power Days at Friendship Ram in Bristol. 0% for 72 months or 20% off MSRP on select new Ram 1500s. And get our $5,000 best price guarantee. Nobody can beat Friendship Ram of Bristol. We're dealing.
Senior night on the hill. Happy Valley High School has been around a long time, since 1923. And there's a certain chill in the air tonight because the sun is going down and the moon is coming up. That can mean only one thing. Halloween is right around the corner. But no tricks or treats tonight, except for those flowers, perhaps, because South Greene and their dynamic quarterback looking to stay undefeated, Casey.
They are. We saw them 2 weeks ago rally past Hampton. Luke Myers gets it done with his arm and his legs. Also on defense, he is the key for South Greene. Meanwhile, on the other side for Happy Valley, Matthew Vaughn, their running back, over 1,000 yards on the season rushing in only 7 games. If Vaughn's going to have a big game, Happy Valley has a chance to pull off the upset.
As we mentioned, senior night on the hill. Matthew Vaughn wants to go out in style, and many of his teammates want to as well. So bring your blanket. You've got the best seat in the house. Friday Night Rivals. It's our final football game of the season, and we're going to bring it to you live with a kickoff on Senior Night from the Hill right after this.
Legendary.
During the Today's the Day event, lease a new 2020 Tacoma SR Double Cab for $179 a month or get big customer cash on Tacoma, 4Runner, and Tundra up to $2,250. Toyota, let's go places.
Such a simple word, but a not-so-simple thing. Life is beautiful, but fragile. It's the ebb and flow of time and a reminder that nothing is forever. It connects us and gives meaning. It's joy and pain. Life is unpredictable, but essential.
I am your health partner for life.
For life.
For life.
For life.
HMG is your health partner for life.
For 85 years, Citizens Bank has focused on you, the local people and businesses in the communities we serve. Locally owned, the bank makes decisions here, not in Nashville, New York, or Atlanta. We support our communities. Citizens Bank Stadium is one of the many projects we're proud of. In person or online at citizensbank24.com.
At Citizens Bank, supporting our neighbors and businesses and their successes is a priority, and it will continue to be a priority in the future.
Here's to 85 more years helping you with your financial needs.
Here at East Coast Wings and Grill, we value the communities we serve and appreciate the opportunity to be good stewards, especially during this challenging time. That's why we're proud to support high school sports as a Friday Night Rivals sponsor. Our employees are going the extra mile to ensure that our food is prepared and packaged in the cleanest possible environment. And as always, we offer delivery options with DoorDash and Easy Cater. Call or visit online to place your takeout order today. That's East Coast Wings and Grill, Kingsport and Johnson City.
Toyota's Friday Night Rivals, driven by your local Toyota dealer.
The Sky 5 drone high above Happy Valley High School tonight as South Greene tries to stay unbeaten. Happy Valley trying to get a share of the district title. Here's your visitors coming on the field. The Rebels all fired up looking for that undefeated streak to remain, while Happy Valley, well, they've got a streak of their own, Casey.
They've won four in a row. They're trying to get a region championship along with South Greene if they win. As for our players of the game, of course, Luke Myers for South Greene, the quarterback, plays defense as well. He does everything for South Greene. He is their key. On the other side, Matthew Bond, the key to Happy Valley, over 1,000 yards rushing just seven games. He has to have a big game. Now let's look at the keys to the game. For South Greene, stop the run. Happy Valley, they like to run the football. You make them pass. Advantage South Greene, avoid turnovers. And for Happy Valley, get some biscuits. That's what they call turnovers up here. And they can contain Luke Myers, get some biscuits. They have a chance.
It's perfect weather for high school football. 45 degrees. And take this, Dave Dirks. No chance of rain. Zero. And there is a Halloween feel to the air, Casey. It's not that far away, just another night away. And will we have tricks or treats tonight?
South Greene is hoping that it's all treats. Happy Valley, the underdog, did like to pull off the trick here and pull off the upset and perhaps get a three-way tie. Of course, the other game tonight, PJ, in this region worth keeping an eye on is Hampton at Cosby. If Hampton and Happy Valley both win tonight, there's a three-way tie for first. If South Greene wins, they win the title outright.
We talked about Matthew Bond, his talent. He grew up playing soccer. He's only played football for 3 years, so he goes back to his soccer life here to kick off. He's got a good leg. Back deep for South Greene, Jalen Ingram. He can do some damage. It's a short kick, and South Greene's going to field it. They'll get pretty good field positions. They go up the left side of the field up to almost the 40-yard line. Here's your offensive stars led by Luke Myers. He can do a little bit of everything, Case.
He can. His other weapons, Mark Crum. We saw him, Corey Hauser as well. Those are the other guys in the offensive line. The key, any quarterback would tell you that.
So Myers will be under center tonight. South Greene's offense, well, they love to run the ball, but they can throw it if they have to. Myers can switch it up for you. From the shotgun, they'll run some veer out of the shotgun, some power, and they can also throw from this formation as well. It's going to be Myers, straight handoff, and up through the middle goes South Greene. That is Mark Crum. Here's your defensive setup, Case.
These guys have their hands full of this high-powered South Greene offense, but the linebackers are going to be the ones that have to commit to stopping the run here, make anybody but Luke Myers beat you. If you're Happy Valley, that's got to be your game plan.
Usually when South Greene starts handing off to Mark Crum, it sets up another play where Myers will fake the handoff and keep it himself. A little option, perhaps. In motion. Myers back to throw. It will be a little screen out here to his receiver. And that's Preston Bailey, who gets a really nice game for a Carter County Bank first down.
Nice patience there by Bailey on that one. He had a couple defenders in his way, but he showed good patience. He let the blocks develop out in front of him here. Look at him just kind of taking his time here, surveying the field, does a good job picking up the first down, and those blockers did a good job not having any illegal block in the back. First down for South Greene.
South Greene to midfield. Myers from the shotgun. He'll throw it again. It's too high, and that's incomplete. Welcome, Facebook fans. East Coast Wings and Grill. You've been our sponsor all year long for our Facebook Live coverage, and we appreciate that. I know the folks out in Facebook land appreciate it as well. We've really been impressed with the numbers of viewers that we've had on Facebook Live all over the country and all over the world, actually. So welcome in to Carter County, Tennessee. Myers running the option, giving to Crum, and now he's going to push him in the back and get another couple of yards. That's kind of a unique option play.
Yeah, not often you see the quarterback being the lead blocker there from behind and pushing. We got somebody with their helmet off, so they'll have to come out for a play on that Happy Valley defense. But watch number one here turn into a push from behind, and hey, quarterback will do anything to help his team win.
We said he was an all-around player, and he just goes out and proves it on that play as he blocks the running back in the back and gives him a little boost. So Myers has got his team past midfield now. The South Greene offense, clean as a whistle so far. Coach Jarrett looking on. Myers, another throw. He's going to go on a scramble up the middle. He's got a hole off to the right side. He's breaking loose. He's got speed down the right.
like he was going to be dead to right there in the pocket. He just sneaks out there, and then he had a couple of blockers outside. Watch here, the clean pocket. He steps up. There's nobody there.
Three defenders right there, and he loses them all.
Yeah, but a missed tackle there. Then watch the receivers out front blocking a little caravan, and Myers embracing the contact.
Live action now as Myers runs it. And down to the goal line, just short, Casey.
And again, he just did it on that play. Myers does not shy away from the defenders. He looks for the guys, and he just will run over you, and that's what he did on that play right there. Showing good strength. Watch him just lower his shoulder here on this run, and the defender is going to go backwards.
Oh, wow. Hard hit by the quarterback. Under center now. He's just going to sneak it in. And they say it's a touchdown. The officials are going to agree, I believe. And they have. Well, nothing hard about that. The Luke Myers option show and the Luke Myers power show. Yeah,
you, saw him. He went right underneath, took that under center there, that snap, and just snuck it right in for the one-yard touchdown. A perfect way to start the game for South Greene as they're looking for a 10-0 regular season.
Jay Higgins comes on for the extra point. And it's right down the middle. So South Greene draws first blood. You're watching Friday Night Rivals, powered by your local Toyota dealers.
Friendship Ford is your Ford truck headquarters. Drive a new Escape for $199 a month or get up to $15,000 off new F-150, all with an any reason 3-day exchange, a free lifetime warranty, and a $5,000 best price guarantee. Nobody beats Friendship Ford of Bristol. We're dealing.
This is home. So is this. And this. But home isn't just the stunning views or the rugged beauty. It's what you make of it. It's a place for joy and peace. A safe haven. Where memories are made. It's all of these things. Home is a feeling, and it's created by the people around you. This region is home, and we're so proud to be a part of it.
Our last slide there about co-signing agreements. I know we haven't actually made a that's lunch.
The Relief by Jersey Mike's. Be a sub above.
Back here at Happy Valley High School, the Sky 5 drone showing you a beautiful shot of the hill. That's what they call this facility here at Happy Valley. The Sky 5 drone, as always, powered by Empire Ford. So Higgins will tee it up for South Greene. Matthew Bond will be back deep to return for Happy Valley. It did not take South Greene very long, Casey, to get those 7 points. Their offense is pretty dynamic and hard to stop.
They are. 2 minutes, 45-second drive there for South Greene. Happy Valley, they're a team that likes to run the ball, so it's important they stay within a score or two so they can stay with their offense. If they fall behind by a couple touchdowns and have to throw it, that's not what they want to do offensively.
So Higgins will boot it off, another Toyota kickoff, and kick it away from Bond. Happy Valley will bring it up across the 30-yard line. It'll be first down for the Warriors. Here's your offense. The quarterback, Eli Ayers, the Bond, of course, number 22. He's the focal point of this offense, Casey.
Yeah, Andrew Little, Gabe Nichols, those receivers, they're going to have to make some plays because you know South Greene defensively, they're going to have all eyes on number 22, Matthew Bond.
Ayers under center. South Greene takes their formation in defense. It's a pitch to Bond. He has a hole, and Bond's going to rip off a nice run there. As he gets about 6 yards. The South Greene defense, Luke Myers, again, is the guy you need to watch.
Yeah, also Corey Hauser, Mark Crum, a lot of guys play both offense and defense at these 2A levels. They don't have a ton of numbers, so a lot of guys have to play both ways.
Myers told us in one of our previous interviews he really likes hitting people more than getting hit. He likes that free safety position.
Well, he can hit people quarterback, too. We saw it 2 times on that last drive. He was initiating contact.
Ayers waiting for the snap from the shotgun this time.
I got a false start against Happy Valley.
That's That's not going to help the offense.
Snap. Ball start. Offense number 44. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
There's Sean Jones, the head coach of the Rebels. They are 9-0. He said they're looking for history. Only once before have they gone undefeated in the regular season, won a region title. So they are looking to do something they don't do very often down in South Greene.
Yeah, he was really interesting to talk to this week. Loves to talk about football and said he'd gotten a lot of reaction from our previous television game. He was telling us about that. Ayers is going to put it in the air. It's going to be caught and then dropped.
As Gabe Nichols. And again, that's important for Happy Valley. They have to be able to throw the ball, and that's a nice play. Nichols, you know, if this is the NFL, he could have gone up and run with that one. There was no defender down, but he went down to get knees, so they're just short. It's going to be 3rd and inches.
So he was able to secure that football. 3rd and inches, and you got Matthew Bond. I'd say your odds are pretty good. From under center. Hand off to the fullback. He should have enough for that first down.
Yeah, the fullback, they love to get some carries instead of always blocking. Landon Babb picks up enough for a Carter County Bank first down.
Just over the 40-yard line now. First down for the Warriors. Really cool night in Carter County. Need a blanket if you're in the stands or the press box. Matthew Bond off tackle, breaks one tackle, but he can't break two. South Green's all over him this time. He'll only get a couple.
Really good pursuit there defensively by Corey Hauser, and then Luke Myers comes in as well. That's the one thing you're going to see, these white jerseys. They all hustling to the football here, not just one person trying to bring down Matthew Bond. Great group effort there by the South Green defense.
Second down and long. Ayers under center. Fakes it to Bond. He's going to put it in the air over the middle, and it's complete. Logan Groom coming out to make that catch. Not enough for a first down, but it will be 3rd and about maybe 3.5, 4 yards. Here's adjusting his neck, ready to go from under center now. They're going to run a sweep off tackle. There goes Matthew Bond up the middle. He'll get the first down, but then the secondary trips him up. I thought he was gone for a second, Casey.
He really showed his explosiveness on that run. Did Matthew Bond picks up the Carter County Bank first down, but take a look at this replay. It looks like he shot out of a cannon here. Gets past that D-line. And, yeah, good tackle by Chandler Fillers.
That's what the coaches call running downhill. On the hill, he's running downhill. Matthew Bond, your senior running back, over 1,000 yards already this season. It'll be Bond again on the right side. Going to cut it back left. There's a hole there to the 40. He's up to the 30. He's going to try to fake out one. He does. Spins. He stays on his feet. Oh, what a run by Matthew Bond.
You can hear the crowd going crazy after that run. What a play by Matthew Bond. He could stop on a dime. Check out the replay here. It's coming up right here. Stops and lets a couple guys go by. Spin move.
Wow.
That's something you do on the PlayStation.
He was a video game on that play, no doubt about it. So Happy Valley's on the move now. Down 7-0. It's been Matthew Bond, as expected, carrying the load. Bond again on the left side. Crashes down for just a couple. Met head on there by the defense.
Yeah, Chandler Fillers again with the stop. Those two guys were going low. See who could get lower. Watch here at the end of this play. 22 goes low and 2 goes even lower defensively.
How low can you go?
They say low man wins.
It does in football. 4 minutes and 18 seconds to go here in the first.
This is a great response by Happy Valley. They have to be able to finish this drive, though, against South Greene. It's one thing to move the ball between the 20s. You have to finish if you get inside the red zone.
Matthew Bond, the pitch to him. He's met by a couple.
Of course, both of these teams, PJ, were off last week, so you would think they got a little extra rest. Matthew Bond should be ready to go for upwards of 30-some carries tonight if Happy Valley has this game go the way they would like it to.
When you say workhorse, he truly is. There he is. Not a big guy, but is well-built, very fast and elusive, stronger than he looks. It'll be the pitch to Bond off the right side. He's got a target on his back, and boy, he's hit hard by Luke Myers and a couple of South Greene Rebels.
And Jalen Ingram also there on the tackle as well, number 21 for South Greene. And now it's going to be fourth down, and this is definitely a go-for-it situation. If you're Happy Valley, they tried to pitch to the far side of the field. Good pursuit there. Luke Myers and Ingram lowers the boom for South Greene. It's going to be fourth and three from the 15, and no hesitation for Happy Valley to go for this.
Under center. It's the pitch. Bond off the right side. He's got that first down mark in his sights, and I believe he has it. He is so hard to stop. Officials agree it is a first down.
Yeah, you see Matthew Bond, he was helping the officials make the call there. He's standing right there. That's a first down, gentlemen.
This looks pretty easy to call. I mean, he falls right there. You can see the marker. Carter County Bank first down for Happy Valley. Say knocking on the door. But can they knock that door down? They're in the Toyota red zone.
I think Bond has had six straight carries.
Make it seven. Bond up the middle. Short of the goal line.
Defensively, you have to wonder in this position, you're like, okay, when's the play? They're not going to give it to them.
Right.
And they just 22, 22, 22. Then eventually they go play action or Ayers maybe keeps it on a bootleg.
John Jones looking a little concerned, and why not? Happy Valley that close to the goal line.
This drive now has been over 8 minutes for Happy Valley.
Perfect Happy Valley football. That's what they want. They want to eat that clock, but they want to score as well. Ayers this time will keep. He's going to put it in the air, and it's deflected and almost intercepted by Fillers.
Man, those balls, when they get tipped by one of the receivers, if you're on the offense, you're kind of just holding your breath here when you see this ball.
He did have a receiver open. He overshot his receiver there. That was the fullback, I believe, Landon Babb, who was open. Threw it a little bit high and a little too hard, and they're lucky that wasn't intercepted.
Yeah, if that would have hung up in the air for another maybe half a second, it probably would have been picked off here. But it's third and seven. I would not be surprised if they go back to Bond here. Maybe look at this as two down territory.
Could go to the wide side of the field. Now it's going to be a roll out by Ayers. Plenty of time. He's going to put it up in the air. It's deep. It's caught. And is it a touchdown? We're waiting for the officials to rule it. Are they saying he was out?
Yeah, they're saying he must have stepped out of bounds.
That was Andrew Little who went high to make that catch, but just came in out of bounds.
See, we get a replay here. See, on the right foot, when he first threw that, I thought it was going to be too far.
What a great catch. Oh, boy. He only needs 1 foot down. Did he come on the line?
Yeah, that's what it looked like. It may have been on the line. Hard to tell from that angle, but you know, those referees are right there, so yeah. Certainly they'd have the best view.
They've really done a great job this year. Great catch. Either way you look at it, Andrew Little, that was terrific. But it's now fourth down, the biggest play of this first half for Happy Valley. So while they talk about it, we're going to take a break. You're watching Friday Night Rivals, powered by your local Toyota dealers.
Welcome to the big leagues, where our go-kart all-stars take personal shopping to the next level. They always bring their A-game, so you get groceries carefully selected specifically for you.
These are passionate professionals, ensuring every fruit and vegetable, every cut of meat is exactly the way you like it. This is plump. That is juicy. And this is lean. Order Go-Kart curbside pickup online for personal shopping at the highest level.
One, two, three, up!
During the Today's the Day event, lease this 2020 Camry LE for $199 a month or get the last of the 2020 Camrys with 0 for 60 financing or get up to $3,000 customer cash. Toyota, let's go places.
Tonight's Facebook Live game coverage is sponsored by East Coast Wings and Grill.
The Sky High Drum giving you a great view of the hill here at Happy Valley High School. Okay, Casey, it's fourth down. You've got the best running back in the district, but you've also got a defense that knows he's probably going to get the ball. So what do you do on offense?
You got to throw it here. I mean, this is the 14th play of the drive for Happy Valley, but you need 7 yards. You can't just toss at the ball and say, go get me 7 yards here. I think you maybe do a screen to him or... you know, maybe throw it up to look like a one-on-one coverage at the bottom of the screen here.
Ayers is in the shotgun. He fakes the bond. He does throw it up in the end zone, and that's going to be knocked down incomplete. Little was out there, but there was three defensive backs on it. So we're going to take a break. You're watching Friday Night Rivals, powered by your local Toyota dealers. They knock that ball down.
This financial literacy tip is brought to you by Citizens Bank.
This week's tip, put your savings on autopilot. Having a good savings plan is a key factor to financial freedom. When you have a well-established savings, like an emergency fund, those pesky surprises won't cause your finances to crash. The easiest way to create savings? Make it automatic. You can set up automatic transfers to your savings or have your direct deposit split into separate accounts. The best part about auto savings, you don't have to think about it, and your accounts will soar to new heights all on their own.
To learn more about Citizens Bank, go to citizensbank24.com or come by one of our convenient locations.
Ricky Matthews and Keith Roberts piloting the Sky 5 drone tonight. Loving this view from high above Happy Valley High School. Beautiful football field here surrounded by those tall pine trees. The neighborhood behind, flag flying in the distance. And a cool, cool night for high school football. Big game tonight. And Happy Valley has the formula to beat South Greene. You eat up that clock, but you've got to score. And they didn't score, Case.
They didn't. They took 8 minutes and 6 seconds off the clock. They took it down to the 12-yard line, but couldn't get any closer.
Corey Hauser got the fake, but now here comes Luke Myers on the option as he breaks out for a 21-yard run. He's up to the 21, I should say. Great fake there by Myers, and he had the old multiple fake, and then he just took off.
Myers does this so well. They fake the jet sweep, then they fake the handoff to Crum. Big game for Luke Myers, and now they get a little breathing room. Because of that long Happy Valley drive, we have almost 30 seconds to go here in the first quarter.
Now this could be the final play of the quarter. Myers from the shotgun's gonna put it in the air, and that is complete. That was Clint Lamb out there making that reception for the first down. Another Carter County Bank first down. About 19 seconds left here in the first.
South Greene does not have to run another play here. The play clock's at 20. The game clock is under 10.
Looks like they probably won't get this playoff. Only 3 seconds left. Myers taking his time, and that is the end of the first quarter. So South Greene holds on with a 7-0 lead after one. Luke Myers has been the star so far. You're watching Friday Night Rivals, driven by your local Toyota dealers.
It's never been a better time to buy at Friendship Hyundai. New 2022 Sun for only $169 a month or 0% for 72 months on all 2020 Santa Fe, Sonata, and Tucson. Nobody beats Friendship Hyundai of Bristol and Johnson City. We're dealing.
Such a simple word, but a not-so-simple thing. Life is beautiful, but fragile. It's the ebb and flow of time and a reminder that nothing is forever. It connects us and gives meaning. It's joy and pain. Life is unpredictable, but essential.
I am your health partner for life.
For life.
For life.
For life.
HMG is your health partner for life.
For 85 years, Citizens Bank has focused on you, the local people and businesses in the communities we serve. Locally owned, the bank makes decisions here, not in Nashville, New York, or Atlanta. We support our communities. Citizens Bank Stadium is one of the many projects we're proud of. In person or online at citizensbank24.com.
At Citizens Bank, supporting our neighbors and businesses and their successes is a priority, and it will continue to be a priority in the future.
Here's to 85 more years helping you with your financial needs.
All trophies and plaques for WCYB's Friday Night Rivals are provided by Eddie's Trophies and Gift Shop in Bristol. Eddie's Trophies also offers medals, plaques, acrylics, glass, and crystal pieces for your business, school, or sports team. That's Eddie's Trophy and Gift Shop, online at eddiestrophies.com.
The Honda Accord LX is in a class all by itself. It has upscale styling and standard Honda sensing to help improve awareness on the road. With more horsepower than the Nissan Altima S, and more torque than the Toyota Camry L. Maybe that's why Car and Driver called it America's best midsize sedan. Now is a great time to get a great deal on the Accord. Contact your Honda dealer to learn more or shop online.
Toyota's Friday Night Rivals, driven by your local Toyota dealer.
And we're back to live action as Hauser gets the handoff.
Fumble.
And the ball is loose.
Happy Valley got it.
Happy Valley says they have it, and they do. Hauser popped it open.
That is the play you need when you're the underdog. You need to create turnovers. They got a biscuit, their first biscuit of the game. That's what Coach Jarrett told us on Monday, PJ. That's what they call them up here on Warrior Hill. They call them biscuits.
And they're wanting to put a little gravy on those biscuits with the touchdown. Look at the replay. Hauser makes a nice cutback. But as he goes down, the ball will pop loose as he tries to get a little extra effort. And big number 74 and a couple of those guys pulling on him, and that ball comes loose. So Happy Valley will take over and try to get back in the end zone. They got close on their first possession. They've shown they can eat the clock here. Ayers is going to fumble it. Now he picks it up, and he's going to run, and he's going to lose some yardage.
The most important thing is he got the ball back. He did lose maybe about a yard here, but that would have been disastrous for Happy Valley. They turned that ball back over. Ayers looks like he's shaken up a little bit. Yeah, you wonder if Happy Valley may
run some wildcat here.
Or maybe take a timeout, give him a little bit to catch his breath.
Now they send him back in there. 12 seconds left on the play clock. They better hurry.
They're not going to get this playoff.
Nope.
That's a delay game.
Fitz, 5-yard penalty, second half.
Really, there's no reason for that. I mean, you saw when you called him over, you weren't going to have much time. You had to come out and just snap it right away.
Yeah, I think with him, you know, hobbling a little bit, it took him a little longer to come over there and then get the formation. You know, the play clock starts as soon as the play ends. So by the time they got everybody off that pile and, you know, it kind of that 40 seconds goes quickly there. So now all of a sudden it's second and 16 for Happy Valley. They're going the wrong way.
They need a big play here from the shotgun. Ayers hands it to Bond up the middle. He's going to get back to the original line of scrimmage. He really does have that explosive first step, doesn't he?
He does. He does. That's twice he's kind of been tripped up past the line of scrimmage where it looks like he was going to break long runs here. They got the ball marked at the 49-yard line of South Greene.
Not sure what his 40-yard time is, but his 10-yard time is unbelievable.
Ayers fakes it. He's going to put it in the air. He's going to try. He eludes one tackler, throws it up, and it is complete to Bailey out there. I mean, Little. That was Little making that reception.
Does a great job. We do have a flag on the far side of the field. I think as it stands, it looks like he has enough for the first down. It's a great job by Little, toe-tapping on the sideline here, making sure he stayed in bounds.
Really, Ayers just to stay alive.
It looks like he had 1 foot in, 1 foot out there.
Yep.
And you only need 1 foot in high school, but it looked like he kind of came down simultaneously. One of his feet was out of bounds and one was in.
I think your first foot can't come down out of bounds.
No.
And that is what it appeared to be. But it may not be academic here. We're going to see what the penalty is.
It's a big play. It was third and 12.
Still waiting for the officials to make up their mind. They're going to talk about it one more time.
Looks like they're going over to
pick it up. Oh, he's going to explain it. He's going to explain it as a South Green. So it must be against South Green. Or
I think it's against Happy Valley.
Yeah, he's asking the coach what he wants to do, isn't it?
Let's look one more time here. They did call this a completed pass. Watch the feet. Which one comes down first? Looks like the left foot, that does come in bounds. Yeah, that is a good catch.
That's a good catch.
Yeah, great replay.
Man, we have the best guys in the business. They never miss anything. They always make this look good.
And that's the receiver downfield, offense number 54. After the play, personal foul on the defense, 15-yard penalty. We'll play third down again.
Why are they... Because it was after the play, they call it a dead ball foul, perhaps? Is that why they marked it off after the play instead of offsetting?
Yeah. They called a personal foul.
Oh, right there.
That's hard for Myers to know that he was out of bounds.
Yeah, that's a tough call. Happy Valley, third down and short. Inside handoff to the fullback. He's got some running room, and he's going to get that first down. That was Landon Babb. You knew it had to happen sooner or later. You can't keep giving the ball to Bond. And Babb says, I'll take it and get the first down.
Really nice play call there. Everybody thinks 22 is going to get it, and they go a little counter to the fullback. Landon Babb picks up the first down.
So the drive is alive for Happy Valley. Now, do we have another penalty?
Illegal participation on the defense. 12 men in the field during the play. It's a 15-yard penalty. It's a first down.
Holy cow. Back-to-back huge penalties against South Green. Illegal participation against
South Green. Yeah, 12 guys on the field. Uncharacteristic mistake there defensively. You know, that usually... You got your different sub-packages, depending on the yardages here. Some guys maybe just missed the communication of who's in, who's out. And all of a sudden, Happy Valley, that ball's down at the 25-yard line.
They've gotten a bulk of this yardage off two back-to-back penalties against South Green. Thank you very much. Pitch play. Bond up the middle, spins. Off one tackler, off two. Now the third and fourth. Finally stop him.
Tell you what, that was a great backpedaling by that referee in the middle of the field. He was right near everything, and he just keeps backpedaling away from this play. Watches Bond kind of keep spinning away here, and you see the referee going back.
That kid has such great balance. Holy cow. We said he grew up playing soccer. I suppose he learned that on the pitch. Way to pivot and curl around.
Be second and a long two for Happy Valley as they're inside the red zone.
Pitch play, Bond, right side. He's going to cut back, and as he does, he gets a hole, stays alive, and gets it close down inside the five.
As well as, I mean, obviously the speed is there, but his vision is what impresses me the most for Matthew Vaughn. He always seems to make the right decision on where to go and make his cuts. I love his vision as a runner.
No kidding. He's the stuff. Number 22. Putting on a show for us on Friday Night Rivals. Thank you, Matthew Vaughn. The full moon Friday.
The flag on the play, though.
Repeat second down.
Something in the backfield? He's cutting off there. Motion in the backfield, I'm guessing?
That's going to take away a big gain.
It's going to make it a little bit tougher for the Warriors now.
Coach Jason Jarrett, his sixth year here at Happy Valley, has to like how his team is moving the ball, but, you know, they stalled in the red zone on their first possession, and that run was going to be down inside the five before the penalty brought it back.
Back to live action now.
Looks like the ball is right at the 20-yard line.
20, yeah.
They got to set the chains on the far side. It'll be first and or second and 15. Got a timeout there by Happy Valley here.
So Happy Valley is going to take a timeout. You're watching Friday Night Rivals, powered by your local Toyota dealers.
Today's the day event. Get any remaining new 2020 RAV4 gas model with $1,750 customer cash or 0 for 60 financing. Or lease a RAV4 LE for just $189 a month. Toyota, let's go places.
Look at the visitor sidelines as the Sky 5 drone goes right down the old alley. Not a lot of room over there, but plenty of room on this football field for a great game. We've got a good one right now. South Greene undefeated on the season, leading 7-0 over Happy Valley, but the Warriors are marching, but a penalty on offense has made it second down and 15. This could be one of the key plays of the first half, Casey.
It can. Matthew Bond, just a little stat update, already has 71 yards rushing on 12 carries. That's almost 6 yards a carry for Matthew Bond. But again, it's second and 15 for Happy Valley from the 20. Got to get down to the 5 for a first down.
Bond has over 1,000 yards rushing already this season, adding to that total. He is the workhorse, carries it a lot. South Greene making some switches on defense.
They've still got a couple officials talking here, and the referee is on the far side at the chain gang. Now he's going to go talk to Coach Jones. Now it looks like they moved the down marker 4, so now they're saying 2nd and 8. So they must have marked it off wrong.
Sean Jones is saying, explain that to me. How did they gain those yardage without running the ball? And now he's just rolling his eyes. Not sure if we're going to get an explanation or not. Yeah, I think we are. Well, now they've marked it off again, Casey.
They've taken the ball down to the 15-yard line.
Jason Jarrett says, okay.
And this all comes after a timeout. They had a long time.
Maybe that's why Jarrett called timeout, to say, hey, you marked it off wrong before. And now they're still trying to sort this out. Now the official's talking to Jarrett.
A lot of math going on here. When they got to here, then we had to go back. Now we're going back the other way.
Well,
the The most important thing is to get it right. Obviously, we would like it to be right and fast.
Yes.
At least the referee's getting a workout. He's going sideline to sideline here.
Yeah.
Nice. Back to talking to Coach Jones.
Okay, Coach, here's what I found out.
We're going to have two pizzas ready for you guys after the game.
We marked it off wrong earlier. Now we fixed it. But then we realized we didn't do it right. So now we're fixing it again.
Yeah.
And now Jones says, okay, I think you finally got it right. Now they've moved it back to second down and 10. Right?
It looks like the ball's back on the 20.
Oh, now they're marching it up again.
Now the chains are moving. You can see them moving on the far side again. They're moving.
All right.
So we're back to second and 15, where we were about five minutes ago.
Right. All that for nothing.
And now it's first down instead of second down.
All right. Regardless, Bond up the middle. This time he... No, I'm sorry. That was fullback that time. That was bad. Getting tripped up right at the line.
South Greene said, we already saw this counterplay. We're not going to be fooled again. And they weren't.
They weren't. They were waiting for it.
Second and 13.
Again, what's at stake for these two teams? South Greene wins. They're 10-0 in the regular season. They're already the number one seed for the playoffs, but they will be the undisputed sole region champions. They won't have to share the title with anybody.
There's Bond off the left side. Going to be stopped. Nowhere to go.
And if Happy Valley wins, they will share the region championship with South Greene and Hampton as long as the Bulldogs win at Cosby tonight. They are a big favorite in that game. But if that happens, Happy Valley will be the three seed. They would lose the three-way tiebreaker, so they will have to be on the road for the playoffs. The only way they would be at home next week is if they win tonight and Cosby would upset Hampton.
So you're saying there's a chance?
There's a chance, but again, I cannot emphasize how big of a favorite Hampton is in that game over Cosby. It's third and 11.
Here we go. Ayers from the shotgun. Going to roll to the right. He's going to put it up, and it's incomplete.
He's looking for Gabe Nichols. So now it's fourth and 11.
Ayers on the rollout.
That one
sails just a little high. Helfrich's throws have been high tonight.
See, Nichols was worried about making sure he was in bounds there. So, again, this is the second time Happy Valley has gotten in the red zone. They went for it on fourth and seven last time. South Greene did a good job breaking up that pass. Now it's fourth and 11. They don't need to go. They don't need to score. They have to get down to the five-yard line. Bond's going to be out of the wide receiver.
It's Bond to the left. Ayers is looking his way. He's rolling that way. He's going to throw it up, and it's caught. It's caught.
That's a first down.
Right at the first down marker.
And Matthew Bond was open. He just kind of turned around and boxed out the defender. Made a great catch.
That was Bond. Let's look at it again. Your Toyota replay. Ayers on the rollout. He sees Bond at the last minute break back. Bond, as Casey said, this is the old basketball move. Boxes out the defender.
Does a good job of not letting the defender come through him to break that up there. Really good job by Matthew Bond. You've talked, he was a soccer player, football, but yeah, that move there looked like it belonged on the basketball court, going for a rebound.
Matthew Bond doing a little bit of everything tonight. Happy Valley back in business now.
Coach Jones did a sprint down the sidelines, call a timeout for South Greene. Really good moves for Coach.
So South Greene takes a timeout, and we will as well. You're watching Friday Night Rivals, powered by your local Toyota dealers.
Friendship Ford is your Ford truck headquarters. Drive a new Escape for $199 a month or get up to $15,000 off new F-150, all with an Any Reason 3-Day Exchange, a free lifetime warranty, and a $5,000 best price guarantee. Nobody beats Friendship Ford of Bristol. We're dealing.
At ECU, we have great mortgage options to help you buy your first home, build your dream home, or upgrade the home that you have.
Ready to build the home of your dreams? We've got a loan for that.
Need a new place?
We've got a loan for that.
Looking to remodel?
We've got a loan for that.
So wherever life takes you, we've got a loan for that. And that's what it means to have ECU beside you.
It's pretty good pie.
Why buy your new Lexus from Lexus of Kingsport?
It all starts with the highest quality luxury vehicles.
Our commitment is to provide you with the best possible buying and ownership experience.
Come check out the RX350, one of our top-selling models.
Find your new Lexus at lexusofkingsport.com.
Tonight's Facebook Live game coverage is sponsored by East Coast Wings and Grill.
The Happy Valley Warriors this close to tying the ball game up after another great play by Matthew Bond. Happy Valley's gotten close before, Casey. They've not been able to punch it in. What can they do differently this time?
Well, it'll help that it's first and goal from the four. They haven't been this close to the end zone. I would expect if I was Happy Valley, I would call four Matthew Bond runs here and trust that your best player can get 4 yards on four plays.
So Bond to the right, Bond to the left, and Bond up the middle. One of those is bound to work. We shall find out. There he is, number 22, Matthew Bond. It is Bond. It is the right side. Bond, it's a foot race, and he's going to power his way into the end zone. And we're 1 point away from being tied. Matthew Bond with his 19th touchdown of the season.
Really good blocking here on the perimeter. It's so important. You don't know which way he's going to go, so good job just kind of getting in the way a little bit. And the most important thing is if you're blocking, you got to make sure those hands stay parallel. You can't turn and twist the jersey and make an easy holding call.
So the point after by Happy Valley.
I don't think that was good.
No good. Look at the replay again. Coming right at you. Matthew Bond says, thank you very much. Now let's check out this big check.
Toyota and your local Toyota dealer are combining resources to support our area high schools. We stand together as community partners for our high school athletes and their families to help schools and students get the most out of their high school years. Toyota is proud to join News 5 WCYB, Fox 39 WEMT, and Tri-City CW to provide each host team with a charitable donation to their school. Proudly presented by Toyota and your local Toyota dealer. Tonight's donation goes to the Happy Valley Warriors.
All the folks here at Happy Valley have been so great to work with tonight. Appreciate all the help, guys and ladies. Had a big spread for us here in the press box. We did not expect that. A little bonus coverage tonight. So it's time for Happy Valley to kick off again. Matthew Bond does the kicking.
He did not attempt that extra point. You know, he does the kickoffs, but he did not miss that extra point. That was Cameron Cochran who attempted that extra point that was missed. So it's a 7-6 game. South Greene still in the lead.
Ingram's back to receive for South Greene. Bond will boot it up. This goes down the middle, and Ingram's going to let it bounce, and he takes it at about the 20-yard line. He has an opening, and if he gets to the sidelines, he could be trouble, but there's a whole bunch of Warriors waiting for him. Still, he makes a great return up to about the 40.
Really nice by Jalen Ingram there. That was a 10-play, 49-yard drive with 4 minutes, 40 seconds off the clock for Happy Valley. And watch Ingram. He stops here, and watch how many Warriors fly by.
They really do.
All right, so let's see. South Greene, this is their third possession. They scored on their first one. They fumbled and turned it over on their second possession. Let's see what they can do here on their third possession of the game.
Luke Myers has had a terrific game so far. From the shotgun. Crum behind it. Crum will hand it. That's Crum getting three.
Camden Richardson on the tackle for Happy Valley. And this Myers and Crum, they really held onto that ball so long, waiting to the last possible second to hand it off there. Crum, he took it, but it's really hard for a defense there. They don't know who's going to get it all the way to the last play.
Second down and about six. From the shotgun. Bailey in motion. Meyer's going to keep it off the right side. Blasting over a defender, breaking another tackle and getting down across the 40-yard line. Terrific run by Luke Myers.
And again, Myers embracing, looking for defenders. He is not shying away. He runs over another defender right there. That was Andrew Little on the wrong end of the Luke Myers truck.
That was your Toyota replay. Back to live action now. Myers from the shotgun. This time he's going to put it in the air. A little screen pass that's incomplete. A little bubble screen out there to Caleb Robinson. Coming up at halftime, it's our Friendship Jeep halftime report. We'll have some special features as well. All that coming up at halftime. The Friendship Jeep halftime report here on Friday Night Rivals. Second down and long. Myers to Crum. Crum's got a good hole out there.
He just looked like he slipped and fell there, Crum. It didn't look like anybody tackled him.
Yeah, he had. I think he couldn't believe how open he was. He tripped over the 40-yard line, 35. He has. Look at Myers again with his hand on his back.
Yeah, he just slipped his, kind of lost his footing a little bit there. Going to be third and three. Happy Valley lucky that slip cost South Greene a first down.
There's Crum. Good shot of Crum. Myers hands to Crum again. This time he'll get that Toyota first down. Just rode him right to the off-tackle position. Had an alley, and he took it. Here's your replay. Look at this hole, Casey.
Once again, Myers, he kind of turns into that pusher from behind. Once he hands off the ball to Crum, he becomes a blocker from behind and helps his teammate to gain a few more yards.
Shotgun formation again. Myers waiting for the snap. He's going to do the quarterback draw, and he's got some running room. Myers up the left side, and Myers scores easily, and South Greene's back on the board.
That was a designed run by Myers all the way, and once he got by the line of scrimmage, there was nobody in maroon that was going to bring him down. He kind of broke through the line right here, and then there was nobody else. And he had some linemen out in front blocking him, and he doesn't get touching until he's well in the end zone.
So South Greene will look to add the extra point. Jay Higgins on for that. Shot of Higgins. And there's your kick. And it wobbles and goes through. Myers again on the quarterback draw. Just eating up the dirt. It's 14-6. You're watching Toyota's Friday Night Rivals, powered by your local Toyota dealer.
The birds and the boys.
This rivalry is real.
If you thought this game couldn't get any more heated, we'll see you Sunday night. Cowboys, Eagles, Sunday Night Football on NBC.
You're working hard to keep your business moving forward. With Compulse Integrated Marketing, you can reach new customers and get results. We work with businesses across America, but we have experts right here. There are new ways to reach your customers with video, digital, and social advertising, and we're experts at all of them. Our solutions are affordable, and they work. Compulse Integrated Marketing. Reach new customers and get results. Contact us right now. Let's partner together and keep your business moving forward.
The Sky 5 drone with a great shot of Happy Valley High School. Coming down below and now going high. Got a good one here in Carter County, 14-6. As the full moon shining down on South Greene right now with that lead, Luke Myers. Man, he did it all on that drive, Casey.
He did. Great response by South Greene after Happy Valley scored to get within one. But South Greene now extends the lead out to 14-6. 4:25 left, and if you're Happy Valley, the way they like to possess the ball, on the ground, their ideal situation here would be to run off the rest of this first half clock, score, and then remember, they will receive the second half kickoff.
So Higgins will kick it off. Matthew Bond back there deep for Happy Valley. Last time they kicked away from him, which is probably a pretty good idea. Great shot of that football as it goes into the air. And it's going to be Little going up the right side. He's got a hole, Little up to the 50, where he's met by a kicker who saves a touchdown, perhaps. Great play by Jay Higgins, who met him. Andrew Little was back there with Vaughn. He took that kick up the right side, Case.
He did. That last scoring drive for South Greene was 60 yards, six plays, 2:45 off the clock.
Our drive of the game, of course, is coming up in the fourth quarter. Our experts are pouring over the stats as we speak, looking for the drive of the game, and they'll make that announcement coming up in the fourth quarter. First down for Happy Valley. Matthew Bond hit in the backfield. Spins. He may have gotten a yard. That's about it.
Derek Miller making the stop there for South Greene. It's a great field position here for Happy Valley off that kick return, starting this drive in South Greene territory.
That's Gabe Nichols out to the wide right side. Little in motion. Sweep play, Bond left side. Now he's going to try to reverse the field, but there's nowhere to go but South Greene, and down they go. Well, actually, he didn't go down. He just went back.
A lot of Rebels ready for that one right there.
Talk about running out of options. You run left, and you're like, uh-oh, I'm in the wrong neighborhood.
Yeah, he tries to take this out wide, and there's two guys right there waiting for him. Ingram is one of them. And the other one was Presley Gilliam. Third and 18. South Greene's defense making two big plays so far. Happy Valley, again, third and 18. Not many plays in the playbook for that.
So it's going to be a rollout for Ayers. He's going to throw it out, and it's too low for Little.
So they're certainly going to have to punt the ball now on fourth and 18, so a missed opportunity for Happy Valleys after that kickoff starting in South Greene territory, and they lose 8 yards.
And the worst part about all this, if you're a Happy Valley fan, is there's plenty of time for Luke Myers to get back in the end zone and break this game open. It's 14-6 right now, and Myers is going back to receive this punt. Looks like Little will punt it away. High snap, but Little gets it down. Partially blocked. It's going to roll, and be down there by Happy Valley on the around the 30-yard line.
Preston Bailey for South Greene got a hand on that punt. That was a high snap a little bit, and Bailey was able to come in and get a piece of that. Little had to jump to get in. Watch number three. His knee almost went down there, too, but actually almost hits off the back.
It's his back.
Yeah. Preston Bailey, like he overran it a little bit. It's a good field position now for South Greene. This ball's already at the 38. That was about a 15-yard punt for Happy Valley, so plenty of time for South Greene. And Coach Jared calling his final timeout of the first half here for Happy Valley.
Well, this is a key stand for Happy Valley. I mean, you cannot afford to give up a late touchdown to a team that can score like South Greene. Hey, if you like football, you're going to love what we've got for you Sunday night.
The Birds and the Boys.
This rivalry is real.
If you thought this game couldn't get any more heated, we'll see you Sunday night. Cowboys, Eagles, Sunday Night Football on NBC.
Of course, if you play fantasy football and you've got a lot of those Cowboys on your fantasy roster, you're probably not liking life right now, Casey.
I'll tell you, you know who's probably going to be the starting quarterback for the Cowboys is Ben DiNucci, I believe, from James Madison. Will be the starting quarterback for the Dallas Cowboys.
could be one and done. Dalton, I think, is supposed to be back next week.
Yeah, they ruled him as doubtful. This is for he had a concussion last week.
If I was him, I'd be doubtful. I don't think I'd want to play the Eagles with a headache. Luke Myers from the shotgun. Crum right behind him. Myers going to drop back. Now he's trying to scramble for his life. He throws a little flare out to Crum. He only gets it back to the original line of scrimmage.
You touched on PJ before that first down. This is a pivotal drive for the Happy Valley defense. You're down by 8 points. You're going to get the ball to start the second half. If you can keep South Greene off the scoreboard in the final 2:25 of the half, you would, I think, Coach Jerry, if you told him you're down 8 at halftime, he would take that. If you're down 14-15, a little dicey for Happy Valley.
Myers trying to change that. Another high snap. This time he's going to throw it out there, and he's got his receiver who drops it. Oh, my goodness. Preston Bailey, he was looking toward the end zone and dropped it.
And he had a lot of room to run, too. Bailey was open.
What's this replay? Myers puts it right on the money. Oh, he hit him in the wrong place, the hands. Sometimes that is the wrong place. Bailey will look to regroup after that. That brings us to third and long so far. Happy Valley hanging tough. A little over 2 minutes left in the first half. From the shotgun, Myers going to air it out. Down the middle he goes, and that's over everybody. We watched Myers in the warm-ups. He can throw it 50 yards in the air easily. He's got a great arm. At that time, he had a little too much arm, as you ever shot Corey Hauser. I don't think Hauser was really open. Pretty good defense by the Warriors.
Yeah, they faked a little quick wide receiver screen to the outside, and then they slipped Hauser down the seam and just overshot him. That's a big one. Happy Valley got the stand. In fact, that drive only took 12 seconds off the clock. Huh? Two incomplete passes and a completed pass for a yard out of bounds. It looks like South Greene's going to call their second timeout before this punt. It's 2:13 left here in the first half.
While we got a second, let's check out this message.
You're working hard to keep your business moving forward. With Compulse Integrated Marketing, you can reach new customers and get results. We work with businesses across America, but we have experts right here. There are new ways to reach your customers with video, digital, and social advertising, and we're experts at all of them. Our solutions are affordable, and they work. Compulse Integrated Marketing. Reach new customers and get results. Contact us right now. Let's partner together and keep your business moving forward.
Happy Valley has new life. They're down 14-6, but more importantly, they're going to get the ball here if things go right, because it appears South Greene will punt here on 4th and 10. Do the Warriors have enough time to score? Do they have a play where they can get Matthew Bond in the open where he can use his speed? Those questions could be answered in the next 2 minutes and 13 seconds. Luke Myers, who does a little bit of everything, runs up soccer style and kicks it away. Here comes Happy Valley. That's Little down the right side as he works his way toward the sidelines. And finally, he goes out of bounds just over the 40-yard line.
That was a dangerous play there by Little, catching that punt almost at his shoelaces there on the run. Very easily could have dropped that one, but did a good job bringing it in and got a nice run here. So Happy Valley going to start this drive at the 44-yard line. 2 minutes, 1 second left. They have no timeouts, but at high school, the clock does stop for first downs.
Little has some impressive speed. We've seen him a couple times tonight show off that speed, but they could use it right now. First down for Happy Valley. Matthew Bond up the middle, looking for a seam, and he gets it as he gets close to a first down. Casey, they may have to measure this, but I think he's got it.
I think he's a little bit short, it looks like. First down. You were right. The clock stopped it while they marked it. Now it's running again.
Minute 44 left. Ayers to the air. Screen play. That's going nowhere. Oh, my goodness. Gabe Nichols was greeted by that defense.
Preston Bailey great job there. Getting a loss for South Greene. Trying a quick throw to the outside, and Andrew Little missed the block on Bailey, and Happy Valley paid for it.
Clock continues to tick. Here comes Little, reversing field up to the right side, showing off that speed we talked about. He gets to the corner and out of bounds. That should stop the clock.
Coach Jarrett's looking for
got another first down, Casey.
Yeah, really nice misdirection here. Starts left, comes back to the right, and Coach Jarrett was looking for a late hit out of bounds, and I think he might have a case there. Ball's at the 33-yard line, a minute and 11 left.
That was Bailey that belted him out of bounds.
South Greene just called their final timeout of the first half.
So things are going splendidly for Happy Valley, just as you would hope if you're a Warrior fan. First of all, they stop South Greene. Again, we're going to show you this last hit. Should this have been a flag? You decide. Our Toyota replay. There he is out of bounds, and there comes in the secondary. I don't know. They both kind of got there at the same time. What do you think, Casey?
I think it should have been a flag. It looked like the contact was made there well after he was out of bounds. But the most important people that made that decision are the referees, and they did not throw the flag.
That's why they wear the stripes.
And they don't get to look at a replay like we do.
In slow motion.
Yes.
Hey, you know, November 3rd, that's coming up. Election night, we're going to have some of the best coverage in the Tri-Cities.
With early voting underway, stay with News 5 for coverage of the key races and issues that affect you as November 3rd approaches. Then on Election Day, get up-to-the-minute results on News 5 WCYB, Facebook Live, and WCYB.com.
That's going to be a great night for us at WCYB. Looking forward to election night. I hope you voted. Casey and I both voted the other day. We voted early, not together, separately, separate days, but both times, smooth as a whistle.
At the Slater Center.
At my favorite place. Mm-hmm. Good to see a lot of my old friends there hanging out. Ayers first. Inside handoff to that fullback. And Babb gets a few. Clock continues to tick, down under a minute now.
He was short of the first down here, so that's why the clock did not stop. Second and two.
Losing a lot of time here, getting set up. Ayers under center. Fakes to Bond. Throws it up, incomplete. That'll stop the clock.
Ayers is getting pressure by Corey Hauser. Just got rid of that ball just in time. He was going to take a big hit from Hauser. I think he could kind of sense that somebody was coming behind him here. Watch Corey Hauser, number 24, coming on the blitz, and he was full speed and almost got to him, and he did a good job of letting up and not continuing to hit Ayers. So it's third and about a short two for Happy Valley. The ball's up to 25.
Under center. It's a pitch. It's Bond off the right side. Spins in the air. Ball comes loose, but was he down?
Yeah, he was down. Yeah, referee's running and pointing to the ground. Now the clock will stop because they got a first down, but it'll start again once it's set here. Watch Bond again, kind of like a helicopter here.
This is a helicopter.
The clock is running again. Here's under 30 seconds. They cannot run this ball here.
Here's, there is a flag. That'll stop the clock.
Half a snap, full start. Offense, number 75. 5 yard penalty. It's first down. Clock will start on the ready for play.
You hear the clock on the ready to play here, so as soon as that ball is set, they will
Happy
wind
Valley
that clock.
Needs to get up to the line. There's only 24 seconds here. They don't have time for a play.
Oh, that clock is already running now. They got to really hurry up and spike this ball here.
Ayers is being too nonchalant. Down to 18 seconds. This probably is going to be the final play of the half. Play clock down to 15. Ayers waiting, scrambling. He throws it up, and it's incomplete.
Oh, there was more time on that clock when that ended.
Let's see what they do about this.
There was about a second on that clock when that pass was incomplete. If I'm South Greene, I'm just running off the field until they tell me to come back. But there should be some time left on that clock. You see South Greene, they are. They're leaving. But now refs are like, get back here. There's still some time.
I do believe there was time. We'll probably check it out on one of our great replays. But
it looked to me it was about maybe 1.2 seconds, something like that.
See if we can see it here. You see Ayers is running for his life. Right there, it's incomplete. Because we don't have the clock in the shot. But I think Casey's right. I think there's around a second left, which would give you one more play. Sean Jones is saying, no, I'm not sure about that. He's still not sure about that. Because the clock shows 0-0, but the officials, I look for them to put another second on it. Just talk to the sideline official. There is 1 second left.
1 second, okay.
This will be the final play of the half. Here's scrambling, throws it up, and that's going to be incomplete. And that's going to how the half ends. 14-6 South Greene as Happy Valley threatens a couple of times, but nothing really close to the end zone, Casey. But still, as you pointed out earlier, I think Coach Jarrett would probably take 14-6 at halftime.
Yeah, we can certainly ask them that here right now. But as you mentioned, you know, they had three possessions or three times they got the ball. Really, four times they got the ball in South Greene territory, and only once were they able to score here. But down 8 points, and they're going to get the ball to start the second half. And we'll talk to Coach Jarrett here momentarily when he gets headset on here to ask him about the first half.
Well, so far it's been a terrific showing by Matthew Bond, but he's going to need a little more help than that against this strong South Greene team. They were able to stop South Greene just before that half ended. That turned out to be a key play because Happy Valley was able to run it out. So we are joined now by Coach Jason Jarrett of the Happy Valley Warriors. Coach, thank you for taking time for us. A very tight first half. You got down in the red zone a couple times, but were turned away. How can you change that?
Well, we just got to find a way to finish the drive right there. You know, our guys are doing a really good job up front. Bond's doing a good job running with physicality right there. We just got to find a way to finish the drives, you know. We talked about that before the game. We got to give our best effort, ball security, execution. You know, we just got to find a way to finish the drives right there. We're okay. We're moving the ball up and down the field just fine. You know, defensively, we got to find a way to stop the big plays. You know, we give up two or three big runs. And, you know, we're okay. We're in the thick of things right here. We got the ball coming out second half.
Coach, defensively, Myers, I know you faced him in the past, but just kind of speak to what type of player he is. He seems like he's really tough to defend.
Man, I don't know. You know, I told you earlier this week on the Zoom call, I don't know how you stop him. You just got to find ways to contain him, and you got to find ways to make him snap the ball. And our guys are playing as hard as they can on defense right there. He's got loose on us a couple times, broke the containment down. One time we had him corralled, and he stepped up in the pocket, probably had a 30, 40-yard run. You know, he finds ways to extend plays. This is what great players do, and he's done a good job of that.
That's Coach Jason Jarrett. Coach, best of luck to you in the second half. Thank you for joining us here at halftime on Friday Night Rivals.
Thank you.
So it's South Greene 14, Happy Valley 6 at halftime. Back with our halftime show presented by Friendship Jeep right after this.
Legendary.
During the Today's the Day event, lease a new 2020 Tacoma SR Double Cab for $179 a month or get big customer cash on Tacoma, 4Runner, and Tundra up to $2,250. Toyota, let's go places.
Cut to the Chase by Jersey Mike's.
Thank you, Jake. Have a great day.
Thank you.
Be a sub above.
Such a simple word, but a not-so-simple thing. Life is beautiful, but fragile. It's the ebb and flow of time and a reminder that nothing is forever. It connects us and gives meaning. It's joy and pain. Life is unpredictable, but essential.
I am your health partner for life.
For life.
For life.
For life.
HMG is your health partner for life.
How can I help you?
Hey, you're still open.
Yes, we are here Monday through Saturday, 7 a.m. to 7 p.m.
That is really convenient.
With Drive-Thru Plus, our interactive teller machines, you have access to traditional banking services during non-traditional times, all from your car. Bank of Tennessee and Carter County Bank. Solutions made simple.
It's Jeep Adventure Days at Friendship Jeep. New Jeep starting at $15,900 or 0% for 84 months. You can own, not lease, a new Jeep for zero down, $199 a month. Nobody beats Friendship Jeep of Bristol. We're dealing.
Welcome to the Friendship Jeep Halftime Report, home to the Any Reason 3-Day Exchange Lifetime Warranty and the $5,000 Best Price Guarantee. At Friendship, we're dealing.
Back here at Happy Valley High School for the Friendship Jeep Halftime Report, South Greene holds off Happy Valley at the end of that first half to lead it 14-6 here at halftime. While we got a second, why don't we check out the Happy Valley Band? Educator Spotlight.
Welcome back to Friday Night Rivals. We have your Northeast State Community College Educator Spotlight. We're talking to Happy Valley High School's principal, Doug Mitchell. He's joining us to talk about navigating COVID-19 in education. We've been talking a lot about this with each of our principals on Friday Night Rivals. And Mr. Mitchell, just talk to us a little bit about there at Happy Valley, how you all have kind of taken this on and really empowered your students in the learning process?
Well, obviously from the spring through this fall, we have all been hit with the phenomena that with the COVID-19 that has presented the greatest challenge that most of us will ever have to deal with. And I will say that from our central office staff down through our teachers and the staff that here at Happy Valley High School, they have been incredible of facing and meeting that challenge for providing the best opportunities with our students. So we've had to do a lot of quick learning. We've had to really up our use of technology and what our teachers are doing, what our students are doing. And so that's the other thing. It has really been a collective effort on our school community with parents and students for us to have any success at all.
Well, I can't ever get off these interviews without saying thank you to our education heroes. I know how difficult it has been on many of you and your families kind of taking everything on, as well as our students as well. So we just give you a big shout out and a thank you for everything that you and your staff do.
We appreciate that, because most people who don't go to a school on a regular basis don't understand, and especially in this crisis that we've been facing this fall, even more so, that our teachers have done an incredible job of trying to present our students with the best learning opportunities each and every day.
Well, thank you so much again, and thank you all for watching here at Friday Night Rivals. We have more coming up right after this.
Tonight's Educator Spotlight is presented by Northeast State Community College. We're here to get you there.
Thank you, Olivia. We told you it was going to be a good one, and it is. South Greene, 14-6 right now at halftime. More of the Friendship Jeep Halftime Report after this.
Shop your next vehicle at BillGattonHonda.com. Handle your entire purchase online, and we'll bring it to you. With no payments for 90 days and excellent interest rates, this is as easy as we can make it.
And remember, at Bill Gatton Honda, we have a Honda with your name on it.
Warren Heating and Cooling, the comfort experts. The temperatures are hot with high humidity. Warren Heating and Cooling invites your call now. We'll install a system to fit your needs and provide you top service. Carrier, turn to the experts with Warren Heating and Cooling.
Continuing education of the latest dental techniques and the investments in technologies, including the XNAV computer-guided surgical implant placement science, make the Center for Family and Implant Dentistry the clear choice to improve your smile. 24/7 at planningsmiles.dental.
Hey, call again. Our water makes my skin and hair feel like I'm 90.
How do you feel about high-efficiency water softeners from Culligan Water?
What?
How do you feel about smoother skin and luxurious hair?
I feel very good about that.
That's the power of water.
It's never been a better time to buy at Friendship Hyundai. New 2022 Sun for only $169 a month or 0% for 72 months on all 2020 Santa Fe, Sonata, and Tucson. Nobody beats Friendship Hyundai of Bristol and Johnson City. We're dealing.
For 85 years, Citizens Bank has focused on you, the local people and businesses in the communities we serve. Locally owned, the bank makes decisions here, not in Nashville, New York, or Atlanta. We support our communities. Citizens Bank Stadium is one of the many projects we're proud of. In person or online at citizensbank24.com.
At Citizens Bank, supporting our neighbors and businesses and their successes is a priority, and it will continue to be a priority in the future.
Here's to 85 more years helping you with your financial needs.
Shop your next vehicle at BillGattonHonda.com. Handle your entire purchase online, and we'll bring it to you. With no payments for 90 days and excellent interest rates, this is as easy as we can make it.
And remember, at Bill Gatton Honda, we have a Honda with your name on it.
You're watching the Friendship Jeep Halftime Report, home to the Any Reason 3-Day Exchange Lifetime Warranty and the $5,000 Best Price Guarantee. At Friendship, we're dealing. Boston Medical Group is proud to recognize our scholar athletes, celebrating excellence in athletics and academics.
I'm Dr. Emily Campbell, primary care and sports medicine physician with Holston Medical Group here in Bristol. I'm honored to announce the HMG Scholar Athletes of the Week. We have Mark Crum from South Greene High School and Eli Ayers from Happy Valley High School. On behalf of HMG, congratulations to both Mark and Eli for their accomplishments not only in their sport but in the classroom.
South Greene's Mark Crum takes pride in academics.
My very first and only B was in second grade reading, and from there on I was like, nope, this isn't going to happen anymore, so I've always made sure to keep straight A's.
The senior holds a 4.36 GPA in addition to lettering and football all 4 years of high school. While Crum has a passion for football, it's his work with Move to Stand and the Isaiah 117 house that means just as much.
To these other people, when you step up and you step in for them and you help them, it makes a difference for their whole day, week, or maybe even their year. And it's something that you don't really even think about a whole lot, but they'll remember that.
Crum already knows what's next. He plans on attending the United States Military Academy at West Point and wants to use that platform to continue to help others.
One day I just, you know, realized how I've helped people here, I can help people in third world countries that don't have that either. And that's something that would be really cool to do.
Eli Ayers has been playing sports almost as long as he's been able to walk.
Well, I've played football since I was 5 and baseball since I was 3. And also played basketball from 5 to 8th grade. And they've just, my dad, he played football, and he got me into baseball. They're two really different sports, you know.
It's been a successful run for the Happy Valley quarterback and starting pitcher, who's earned all conference and all region honors.
You just got to make sure that you put your time where it's needed. So, like, I'll go to school, and then I'll go to football. And then if I don't have to do any work after football, I'll go home and do my homework, and then weekends are a big time for me to do homework, too.
But it was his work with others restoring the Happy Valley baseball field when it flooded 2 years ago. That's one of his proudest moments.
Went in and picked up the rocks, and whenever it flooded the second time, it got a lot of trees and debris in the creek. And so we went in and cut all those trees up and got them out of the creek.
You play baseball. You use that field. How did it feel to be able to clean that up?
Oh, it was a joy, honestly. It really was. You know, it really just shows what a good community we have behind us.
All of HMG's scholar athletes have the opportunity to compete for a $5,000 scholarship to be awarded at the end of the season. With early voting underway, stay with News 5 for coverage of the key races and issues that affect you as November 3rd approaches. Then on Election Day, get up-to-the-minute results on News 5 WCYB, Facebook Live, and WCYB.com.
The amazing display of fall colors is beautiful this time of year, but these same leaves can also present a hazard. As leaves fall on highways, they can create slick, dangerous conditions, especially when wet. Slow down and avoid accidents when driving on leaf-covered roads.
The birds and the boys.
This rivalry is real.
If you thought this game couldn't get any more heated, we'll see you Sunday night. Cowboys, Eagles, Sunday Night Football on NBC.
It's a Sleep Solutions spooktacular event. This Friday and Saturday night, we save 25% on all Nectar mattresses, including the 2021 models. We got plenty in stock, so bring the truck and take it with you today.
Sleep Solutions Mattress Gallery, your solution to a great night's sleep.
One, two, three, up!
During the Today's the Day event, lease this 2020 Camry LE for $199 a month, or get the last of the 2020 Camrys with 0 for 60 financing, or get up to $3,000 customer cash. Toyota, let's go places.
New phone?
Yep, I got a new one when I switched over to Spectrum Mobile. They're faster overall and more reliable.
They all say that. It's just jibber jabber.
Jibber jabber?
Yeah, you know, balderdash.
Hooey.
What?
Did he sense any flapdoodle?
What is flapdoodle?
I think it's like hemming and hawing.
With a little bit of hogwash.
No, they're just faster and more reliable.
Okie dokie. No flim flam.
Spectrum Mobile gives you the fastest overall speeds and the most reliable service coast to coast. It's a better way to mobile. Spectrum Mobile.
At ECU, we have great mortgage options to help you buy your first home, build your dream home, or upgrade the home that you have.
Ready to build the home of your dreams? We've got a loan for that.
Need a new place?
We've got a loan for that.
Looking to remodel?
We've got a loan for that.
So wherever life takes you, we've got a loan for that. And that's what it means to have ECU beside you.
Like that.
It's a Sleep Solutions spooktacular event. This Friday and Saturday night, we save 25% on all Nectar mattresses, including the 2021 models. We got plenty in stock, so bring the truck and take it with you today.
Sleep Solutions Mattress Gallery, your solution to a great night's sleep.
You're watching the Friendship Jeep Halftime Report, home to the Any Reason 3-Day Exchange Lifetime Warranty and the $5,000 Best Price Guarantee. At Friendship, we're dealing.
Well, Casey talked about it. He thought it would be a good first half, and it certainly was, Casey, 14-6 right now.
Yeah, Luke Myers, 2 touchdowns for South Greene, and then defensively, South Greene holding Happy Valley out of the end zone, other than that one Matthew Bond touchdown to get 14-6.
Sean Jones, the head football coach of South Greene, nice enough to join us now. Coach, things didn't go perfectly for you in the first half, but you've got a lead, so you've got to love that.
Oh, yeah. Anytime you got a lead at halftime, it's always big. We felt like we've kind of shot ourselves in the foot a couple times out here, so we're going to regroup it and come out in the second half because, again, like you know, we said a couple weeks ago, we feel like we're a second-half team.
Coach, defensively, Matthew Bond had a couple electric runs there. How do you like how your team defended him?
Well, you know, we made some adjustments. You know, we were kind of out of position there on a couple of his big runs, and all we got to do is make an adjustment like we're supposed to and read our keys. And that's one thing we didn't do here in the first half. Again, probably a little hangover from 2 weeks ago, but we went here and talked, and we think we got it fixed here at halftime.
Coach, could you answer this question? About 5 or 6 minutes left there in the half, there was some confusion about where the ball was marked. You were talking to the official, then they went to the other side. What was going on there?
Well, we feel like they had a big long run on first down, and they come back and said it was they had a false start, and they were trying to say it was second down and 15, and then they come back quarterback and said, no, it's second down and seven. And I went nuts. I said, no, that was a first down run. I said, you can get him first down and 15 if you want to. But I said, that was a first down run. So they said somebody had come on the sideline. Luckily, it had the spot. And the big thing was that the chains had moved. And it wasn't their fault, but the chains had moved. They thought it was a first down and goal, and they didn't see the flag. So it was just a little confusion there. But, hey, maybe it's good stuff for TV.
It certainly did. Coach, it's always great to talk to you. Best of luck in the second half.
Thank you. Thank you, guys.
All right, that's Sean Jones. Nice enough to join us tonight. Now it's Olivia Bailey and the Educator Spotlight for South Greene.
Welcome back to Friday Night Rivals. We have your Northeast State Community College Educator Spotlight. We have Ms. Will Hoyt here with us from South Greene High School, and we're really going to highlight some of the academic accomplishments of South Greene. And Ms. Will Hoyt, we were just talking a moment ago just about how much success South Greene has seen. You were talking about being a reward school. Tell me a little bit about that.
Yes, we've been a reward school with the state of Tennessee for the past 7 years in a row, so that's a very big accomplishment. We've showed growth in all areas over the past 7 years, so to keep that strain going has really been a huge milestone and just speaks volumes to the dedication of our staff and students and all of our stakeholders.
And when we talk about that and start looking specifically at high school, some of the numbers that often stick out are those graduation rates. We were talking how high those are for South Greene. Kind of let us know a little bit about that graduation rate, what that means for the students there at South Greene High School and your staff.
It's super important. We work with every single senior one-on-one. The Niles Morgan Foundation has been awesome the last several years to give us just a guidance counselor that's focused on seniors. And we make sure that they know what's available to them as far as post-secondary. And it's really, really boosted our graduation rate. It's been 97, 98% for the last several years. And that's very exciting. We've also been working on work ethics diplomas. We had 6870 worth ethics diploma this year and our ready graduate status. So we've really been working hard on making sure that our seniors are ready for that post-secondary life.
And we love when our students succeed, and we can tell that's part of your passion too. And I always just like to say thank you, because I know this has been a challenging time for all of our teachers and administrators just to navigate through this pandemic. So thank you and your staff for everything that you've been doing through this semester.
Thank you. It's definitely been different, but my staff has taken that on, and they have really went hard and went with it. And it has been difficult times, but it's nice to have some kids in the building now on the hybrid schedule, and we're looking forward to having them all the time. But the virtual piece has been very eye-opening and a learning experience for all of us, that's for sure.
Tonight's Educator Spotlight is presented by Northeast State Community College. We're here to get you there. You're working hard to keep your business moving forward. With Compulse Integrated Marketing, you can reach new customers and get results. We work with businesses across America, but we have experts right here. There are new ways to reach your customers with video, digital, and social advertising, and we're experts at all of them. Our solutions are affordable, and they work. Compulse Integrated Marketing. Reach new customers and get results. Contact us right now. Let's partner together and keep your business moving forward. Thanks for watching the Friendship Jeep Halftime Report, home to the Any Reason 3-Day Exchange Lifetime Warranty and the $5,000 Best Price Guarantee. At Friendship, we're dealing.
Such a simple word, but a not-so-simple thing. Life is beautiful, but fragile. It's the ebb and flow of time and a reminder that nothing is forever. It connects us and gives meaning. It's joy and pain. Life is unpredictable, but essential.
I am your health partner for life.
For life.
For life.
For life.
HMG is your health partner for life.
It's Ram Power Days at Friendship Ram in Bristol. 0% for 72 months or 20% off MSRP on select new Ram 1500s. And get our $5,000 best price guarantee. Nobody can beat Friendship Ram of Bristol. We're dealing.
trophies and plaques for WCYB's Friday Night Rivals are provided by Eddie's Trophies and Gift Shop in Bristol. Eddie's Trophies also offers medals, plaques, acrylics, glass, and crystal pieces for your business, school, or sports team. That's Eddie's Trophy and Gift Shop, online at eddiestrophies.com.
This is home. So is this. And this. But home isn't just the stunning views or the rugged beauty. It's what you make of it. It's a place for joy and peace. A safe haven where memories are made. It's all of these things. Home is a feeling, and it's created by the people around you. This region is home, and we're so proud to be a part of it.
Back at Happy Valley High School, we've got a good one. 14-6 at halftime, the Sky 5 drone showing the action beneath. And the logo on the field, the Warriors here on the hill at Happy Valley. South Greene will have to kick it off. Matthew Bond back to receive that kick. Happy Valley. As the coach told us at halftime, they've got to figure out a way to get in the end zone. This would be a good start. It's a low kick. Bond's actually going to let it bounce around. He's going to pick it up, and here he comes. He's got a head of steam, but he's going to cut back to the left side. There's a hole there. If he can make that hole, he does. Bond down the left sidelines. One man to beat. Oh, and he cannot beat him. The kicker gets him again.
Well, that was a great play there. But, yeah, Jay Higgins made the stop on Matthew Bond. Let's check out our first half highlights in this game. Luke Myers, you heard Coach Jared say, I don't know how you stop him when runs like this is the reason why he says that. And then Myers sneaks it in from a yard out to make it 7-0 South Greene. Happy Valley, though, would come back with Matthew Bond. He had a great first half. Nice run here. And this is the one that fourth down, incomplete. South Greene's defense with a big play here.
And we're back to live action. Speaking of Matthew Bond, there he goes. Off tackle for a few. For his submarine after about a four-yard gain.
And that was a really good job. I just want to give a shout-out to Higgins, you know, the kicker. He kind of stayed right back there and was the last safety valve. That's the kicker's job, and he did a good job, one, making the tackle. But even if not, you just want to slow him down just a hair to let those other guys catch up, because otherwise Bond, he could have taken that to the house.
Yeah, you give Bond an inch, he'll take a mile. That brings us to second down. Bond, right side, cutting back. He'll get a couple. It's going to be third down and about four.
Let's check out our first half stats. Rushing South Greene, both of these teams over 100 yards on the ground. Neither one likes to get the damage in the air. But time of possession, Happy Valley, almost 17 minutes. You know, that first drive they had in the first quarter, PJ, was over 8 minutes long. They did not score. That drive was longer than South Greene had it for the entire first half.
Certainly, and that's why this game is so close, though. That's Happy Valley's game plan. Eat this clock and try to get the scoreboard. Here goes Ayers with like a little option down the right side. Myers, oh, he fakes Myers out and gets another couple of yards before he's hit out of bounds, and there comes a flag.
You know, when you run it with Vaughn all the time, you're just setting it up. The offensive coaches look, say, we got this one play in our back pocket where they're going to have Ayers keep it, and this one was wide open. The defense, everybody flowing towards Bond, and then Ayers, he does get hit when he's out of bounds right there. That's a really late hit, and they throw the flag. That was Chandler Fillers, and that's going to be a probably be half the distance to the goal because they're inside the 30, so they won't get a full 15 yards.
So big play by Happy Valley to get back in this game.
Sideline warning on South Greene.
Sideline warning for South Greene, so that's no penalty. It is just a warning.
And the next time it happens, if it happens again, it would be a penalty. But now that ball is at the 10-yard, maybe just outside the 10-yard line.
In the Toyota red zone.
Yeah, they got it marked at the 11.
Now you're probably going to see Matthew Vaughn. Sweet play, Bond cutting back to the middle. He breaks a tackle. He's going toward the end zone and falls in for a score. Great second effort by Matthew Bond.
And how about that response for Happy Valley? They're down by two. Will they go for two here? They're going to try and kick the extra point. 11-yard touchdown run by Matthew Bond, his second of the game. It's 14-12, and it looks like Happy Valley is going to go for two here and try to tie the game up. Of course, they missed an extra point on their first touchdown, so that's why they only hit six.
Under center, Ayers. Pitch to Bond, cuts back. He's at the goal line, and he's in. One official said he was in. Now we're waiting for the other official. Yes, they have given it to him. I don't know why there was a delay. The official immediately said he got in. Boy, we've got a good one now. Matthew Bond ties it up with a touchdown and a two-point conversion. It's 14-14. You're watching Friday Night Rivals, powered by your local Toyota dealers.
Today's the day event. Get any remaining new 2020 RAV4 gas model with $1,750 customer cash or 0 for 60 financing. Or lease a RAV4 LE for just $189 a month. Toyota, let's go places.
For 85 years, Citizens Bank has focused on you, the local people and businesses in the communities we serve. Locally owned, the bank makes decisions here, not in Nashville, New York, or Atlanta. We support our communities. Citizens Bank Stadium is one of the many projects we're proud of, in person or online at citizensbank24.com.
At Citizens Bank, supporting our neighbors and businesses and their successes is a priority, and it will continue to be a priority in the future.
Here's to 85 more years helping you with your financial needs.
Back here at Happy Valley High School, where we've got a great ball game because so much on the line tonight, Casey. Happy Valley fighting for their playoff lives.
Well, they're already in the playoffs. They're trying to fight for a region championship. If they win tonight, they will share the region championship. I did look. Hampton was up 39-0 at halftime over Cosby. So certainly looks like if Happy Valley were to win this game, there would be a three-way tie for the region championship with South Greene, Hampton, and Happy Valley.
Jalen Ingram back to receive the kick from Matthew Bond. Toyota kickoff. Plenty of time left here. 10 minutes and 18 seconds in the third. Here we go. Short kick. Fielded by South Greene at the 30. They're going to get a good return out of this. Up to the 40-yard line. That's Fillers. Great field position for the Reds. Facebook fans, thank you so much for watching tonight. Click it in, as they say. East Coast Wings and Grill, what a great job you've done supporting our Facebook Live coverage. We appreciate all you guys. Facebook Live tonight, wherever you are, let us know. You never know, we might give you a shout-out. Speaking of shout-out, how about that? Our camera guys on the ball tonight. You know Halloween's just right around the corner. You see that, huh? Luke Myers taking the snap, riding his fullback. Crum gets it, but boy, Happy Valley said, we've seen that before, Mark Crum. You're not going anywhere.
Yeah, Peyton Primu on the tackle for Happy Valley.
You pointed this out before. Watch him ride the fullback until the very last second. Then he gives it to him.
And if he does give it to him, then Myers starts kind of pushing him in the back to move him forward there. But that time he did hand it off. And Happy Valley, they get a win there on first down, just giving up 2 yards.
Somebody named Peyton from Tennessee, imagine that. Myers from the shotgun, roll out. Still rolling. Now he's going. Avoids one tackle, gets out of bounds, short of the first down.
Such a good job Myers does. You know, defensively, they want to keep him in the pocket, but he can still get outside the pocket there, and he's going to be faster than those defensive linemen that are chasing him. So he's able to turn what would have been a loss into gain of a couple yards. It's going to set up third and about three. Just a heck of an athlete is Luke Myers, and the worst part for everyone else in the region is he's only a junior, so he will be back next year.
Myers on the snap. He's going to keep it, and he's going to be thrown down. No gain for Luke Myers. What a stand by Happy Valley.
Yeah, Camden Richardson, 74. He won that one against Myers. Nice play by Richardson.
I mean, Myers gets pancaked here. Look at this. Bam!
It's fourth down. Now Sean Jones, what's he going to do here? Is he going to go for it? His ball's at his own 47-yard line. See, Myers, you know, he does punt it as well, but you wonder if they're going to maybe try and draw him offsides. Offsides would give him a first down.
They can still pooch it. A lot of options here.
He's too close to pooch it from where he is.
Yeah, he would have to back up.
They tried to draw him offsides.
He did.
I think they took the delay game, yeah, so. They almost got him the jump. They did kind of flinch on that defensive line, but they did not cross the line of scrimmage.
So Myers walks off. Now he walks back on. Of course, he is the punter as well, as Casey mentioned.
And where he was lined up on that previous play, he was too close to the line of scrimmage to pooch it from there.
Runs up, punts it at the last moment, and booms this one. That's going to sail down close to the goal line. Can they stop it?
No. Touchback.
Close, but no cigar. Wow, what a punt from Luke Myers. Great hustle by the special teams of South Greene, though, to get down there. That's Preston Bailey who tried to down the ball on the goal line.
Yeah, just not enough. And really, you know, Happy Valley did a good job because Myers almost, I think, decided to run that ball. But Happy Valley was ready for that and watched the ball just kind of crosses over the end line. Referee's right there, hits him in the helmet.
If it hadn't hit him in the helmet, I think he might have gotten it. The helmet kind of knocked the ball forward.
And that is a big play for Happy Valley. That gives them 20 yards of field position. That ball would have been at the one. Now they're out to the 20.
Here we go. Ayers under center. The pitch to Bond is on the ground. The ball is loose, and I think South Greene may have it.
They do. Presley Gilliam recovers for South Greene, and that ball, that pitch from Ayers looked like it hit Bond in the face mask.
Bond looked like he wasn't expecting that. Now, my question is, no, it's definitely behind him. It's definitely a lateral. Yeah, Bond appeared to not be ready for it at all.
Boy, Happy Valley gets the stop defensively, then turns it over, and that's a killer turnover. South Greene, great field position. The ball's at the 20-yard line. Presley Gilliam comes up with the fumble recovery for South Greene. Big momentum swing here. The Rebels needed that because Happy Valley had all the momentum. See coach saying, watch the screen.
Myers going to keep it. Gets outside, stiff arms. He gets to the corner. He's got a blocker. Still on his feet. Gets close to the 5-yard line. He's brought it up down about the 6 or the 7.
There's a flag on the play here. But, man, Myers did a great job getting away. He could have been sacked there behind the line, but I think most quarterbacks would have. I think this is going to be against South Greene.
Illegal motion on the offense. Number 3, 5-yard penalty, first down.
So that was illegal motion on Preston Bailey. Myers doing a great job of following his blockers until he can utilize that speed of his.
That's a big penalty because it would have been first and goal, probably about close to the 5-yard line for South Greene. Now it's first and 15 from the 25. But with Myers, honestly, 5 yards is not that big of a deal.
Myers right back up the middle, cuts it back to the right. Instead of avoiding the tackler, he goes right at him. Gets some of that yardage back.
A couple linemen are slow to get up for South Greene.
Here's a replay from Friendship Ford. Huge hole right there as Myers back pedals and cuts to the right.
Queen 18. certainly have to think he's going to get serious consideration. I would not be surprised. Honestly, I would be surprised if he is not a Mr. Football semifinalist. You know, they'll be announcing, I believe, five semifinalists here in the next maybe 2 weeks or so.
Myers dropping back to pass. Staying alive, throws it over the middle. It's caught. It's a touchdown for South Greene as Clint Lamb comes back to make that reception and curls into the end zone.
That's all Luke Myers. I mean, there's two Happy Valley defenders right in his face. They had a shot. He escaped and found Lamb open. This is all Luke Myers. Watch, two guys coming right at him, just kind of rolls away, no problem, and throws it on the run. What a throw by Myers.
Higgins will be in for the extra point. All Lamb had to really do was catch it and turn around and walk in the end zone. That's exactly what he did. There's the boot right down the middle. So it's 21-14. South Greene has regained the lead. You're watching Friday Night Rivals, powered by your local Toyota dealers. Oh, that was a dart.
It's a Sleep Solution Spooktacular event. This Friday and Saturday only, save 25% on all Nectar mattresses, including the 2021 models. We got plenty in stock, so bring the truck and take it with you today.
Sleep Solutions Mattress Gallery, your solution to a great night's sleep.
Friendship Ford is your Ford truck headquarters. Drive a new Escape for $199 a month or get up to $15,000 off new F-150s, all with an any reason 3-day exchange, a free lifetime warranty, and a $5,000 best price guarantee. Nobody beats Friendship Ford of Bristol. We're dealing.
It's a Sleep Solution Spooktacular event. This Friday and Saturday only, save 25% on all Nectar mattresses, including the 2021 models. We got plenty in stock, so bring the truck and take it with you today.
Sleep Solutions Mattress Gallery, your solution to a great night's sleep.
Why buy your new Lexus from Lexus of Kingsport?
It all starts with the highest quality luxury vehicles.
Our commitment is to provide you with the best possible buying and ownership experience.
Drive a new ES350 for only $359 a month.
Find your new Lexus at LexusofKingsport.com.
Welcome back to Friday Night Rivals, everyone. The Sky 5 drone high above the hill here at Happy Valley High School. Matthew Bond will be trying to get his Warrior ball club back in this game. They're down a touchdown now, thanks to Luke Myers. Here's your Toyota kickoff. Bond's going to get a chance to return it. Cuts back to the left, up to the 35-yard line, where it will be first and 10. Don't forget about our drive of the game, the Toyota drive of the game, coming up in the fourth quarter of tonight's contest. We'll pick out the drive of the game, brought to you by Toyota.
So how will Happy Valley respond? Again, they had the ball in a tie game. They turn it over on the first play when they got it back there. The fumble, South Greene took advantage. So how will Happy Valley respond now, down by a touchdown?
Still plenty of time here in the third, 6 minutes and 53 seconds. There's Bond going up the middle. Seems the holes aren't quite as big as they were in the first half for Happy Valley. Bonds had to really fight for every yard here in the second half.
Yeah, he did have that 11-yard touchdown. Certainly the big play was that Ayers run on the previous, their touchdown drive, the first possession in the second half here when he kept it. That was the first time he really kept it. And obviously, you know, the defense keying in on Bond and Coach Jones from South Greene telling us at halftime that they kind of changed up their alignment a little bit and said the defense has to read their keys.
Here's waiting for the snap. He's going to keep it. Cuts it back. And that'll bring us up to third and short now. Here's adding a little more to the offense. As for the year, Ayers has completed about 50% of his passes for 473 yards, but he can run the little option play, especially when you have Matthew Bond. When you have a defense keyed on a player, that option really comes in handy.
You see Matthew Bond on the sidelines for this big third down play here. Coach Jerry has his arm around him here, so you have to See who's going to step up and make a play here on third down.
Andrew Little has shown flashes, but it's going to be the backup running back getting that first down.
It's Gabe Nichols. And he got it. That's a big, big play with Bond on the sidelines, getting a little bit of a breather. Now he's back in the game. But Gabe Nichols, a big third down conversion for Happy Valley.
That's the same play they ran when Bond fumbled. So the Warriors keep it alive. Close to midfield now, where it's first down and 10. Ayers under center. It's DeBond. They'll try the left side. But boy, Luke Myers was waiting for him, Casey.
Well, Luke Myers was Isaac Collins as well. Big number 50. Throwing a big, big hit there after Myers kind of slowed up on. Yeah, I'll say this would be the hardest hit of the night we've seen so far. Watch 50.
The old pile driver. Isaac Collins, just a junior as well.
And there's a lot of underclassmen, only seven seniors on this South Greene team. When we talked to Coach Jones a couple weeks ago, he said everybody this past offseason said, well, maybe next year is going to be your year.
He said, what about this year? That was Bond trying the middle. Not a lot of running room.
Be third and 12. Happy Valley. Ball's at their own 44-yard line. They need to get it just past the South Greene 45.
South Greene almost jumped. Now the official says maybe they did. Oh, the official did say. What?
Try to snap. Encroachment. Defense. 5-yard penalty. First down.
Referee said first down. It's not first down. It's third down.
That's what he meant.
Yeah. The third and 7 is certainly better than third and 12 for Happy Valley. Now you can kind of bring back the running game. I think here, if you're going to look at having two downs, if you're going to go for it, and the ball's just outside of the 50-yard line.
Ayers keeping. Well, as Casey said, he just needed to get it close enough to where they could go for it. They certainly have gotten it closer.
And the Ayers kept it this time, but the really good job by the defense of South Greene. That was Bailey on the outside not allowing that receiver to block him, and he came off and made the tackle, and almost looks like South Greene's going to punt it here.
Happy Valley's going to punt it. Ayers looked really frustrated there that they were not going to go for this. So Little's in to punt. Gets it away. It's a low punt. It's going to run forever, though. He's saying the official saying, oh, he touched the ball. He's not roughing the kicker because he did touch the ball. Well, we've got a second. Let's talk to our good friends at Citizens Bank.
This financial literacy tip is brought to you by Citizens Bank.
This week's tip. Put your savings on autopilot. Having a good savings plan is a key factor to financial freedom. When you have a well-established savings, like an emergency fund, those pesky surprises won't cause your finances to crash. The easiest way to create savings? Make it automatic. You can set up automatic transfers to your savings or have your direct deposit split into separate accounts. The best part about auto savings, you don't have to think about it. And your accounts will soar to new heights all on their own.
To learn more about Citizens Bank, go to citizensbank24.com or come by one of our convenient locations. Tonight's Facebook Live game coverage is sponsored by East Coast Wings and Grill.
So Happy Valley playing the percentages. Instead of going for it on fourth down, they'd elected to punt. Now South Greene takes over with a chance to up this total from 21-14 to maybe 28-14.
They're going to start this drive from their own 20-yard line. Just over 2 minutes left in the third quarter.
Luke Myers has had a terrific night. Thrown a touchdown. Scored a couple. Myers going to keep it. He's got some running room if he gets outside, but he's run down from behind. Nice play by Happy Valley's Little to run him down from behind.
But not until he picked up 15 yards. Myers fakes the handoff, keeps it, and then he is over 100 yards rushing now on the night. Hampton, you know, that's a score of this game a lot of people are interested in. They have now, that's a final. Hampton beat Cosby 46-6. So South Greene trying to be the only region champ out of Region 1, 2A. They need a win here to do that.
Myers is looking for running room, and he's got it up the middle as he just breaks through. He's still on his feet. He's still on his feet. He's dragging the defender. Oh, my goodness, what a run and individual effort for the Bank of Tennessee first down.
That's a special player is Luke Myers. South Greene's going to have a good opportunity in the postseason when you have a special quarterback. And again, he is so hard to bring down, such a physical runner here. I mean, that's about the fourth or fifth run, PJ, where the first guy that's made contact with him has not brought him down. He looks a little winded right now. I wouldn't be surprised if he hands this one off to
the Crub. No, it's going to be a pass. And he's got his receiver. That's Spillers down to a five. And he gets an extra boot there. And here comes the flag. That was uncalled for.
As Andrew Little, a little frustration after that play.
Chandler Fillers was wide open. And when he went to the ground, Little was so frustrated. When he got up, he kind of popped it.
Play, personal foul, defense, number three. Half the distance to the goal, first down.
Watch it again. So he's down right there. And then I don't know why Little thought he had to do that.
Coach Jarrett took Little out of the game after that play. So he's on the sidelines now on his first and goal for South Greene.
This is where South Greene wants to be. It's just going to be Crum going in. And he's got the touchdown. Again, though, did you notice Myers had his hand on his back after he handed the ball?
So we'll give Myers maybe a little bit of an assist here on this Crum touchdown run.
Be right there.
Hey, get in there, fella.
Just kind of falls on top of him. That's a touchdown the easy way. Higgins in to kick that extra point. South Greene looking to extend the lead. That's just what they do. It's now 28-14 as South Greene one step closer to finishing the regular season undefeated. Man, you see Crum easily into the end zone. And Myers, look at him, man. He has had a night of work, soaking wet with perspiration, but ready to go for more.
I got a trivia question for everybody out there, and you too here. Looking up some numbers here. Of course, this is the final week of the regular season. We have 23 teams in our coverage area in Northeast Tennessee. Only three teams got to play 10 regular season games. Can you name them? You can think about it. We've got 39 seconds left in this quarter. Let people at home think about it. We'll tell the answer when we come back for the start of the fourth quarter.
Okay.
Only three teams.
I think I've got one. Right,
played a full 10 games in the regular season. Mm.
Did you ever think you'd ask a question like that?
No, but no. You know what? I mean, in 2020.
In 2020, yeah, it's just been the most rotten year of all time. A COVID question, a COVID trivia question from Casey Getz. I think I've got one of the teams. I have to think of the others. I think I actually have got two now. Who's the third? How All right, here we go. Higgins kicking off. Another Toyota kickoff. That's going to be a little hockey slice down the middle. Bond's going to dance around with it. If he runs back to this side, he's got a blocker. If he can get to the corner, he does, but he's got help. And that's all he's going to get. Still a good return out to about the 30.
So Happy Valley now down two touchdowns here late in the third quarter, and they obviously cannot afford to fall behind any more than they already are. Their offense is not predicated with big plays in the passing game to pick up big chunks quickly. This is close to a must-score drive for Happy Valley. It's after potentially one play here. It could be the end of the third quarter.
Here comes the fake to Bond. Ayers kept it that time. That was a good fake. He had me for a second. Then he's wrapped up.
Phillip Blair on the stop.
The Sky 5 drone showing you a wonderful shot from behind the lights tonight as we watch that clock tick down here in the third quarter. That probably is going to be the last play of the third quarter. So we're down to 8 seconds now. So it's 28-14. Does Happy Valley still have time? They still have a quarter to play. We've got more Friday Night Rivals coming up right after this. So I've got two.
Legendary.
During the Today's the Day event, lease a new 2020 Tacoma SR Double Cab for $179 a month or get big customer cash on Tacoma, 4Runner, and Tundra up to $2,250. Toyota, let's go places.
Our last slide there about co-signing agreements. I know we haven't actually made a that's lunch.
The Relief by Jersey Mike's. Be a sub above.
Such a simple word. But a not-so-simple thing. Life is beautiful, but fragile. It's the ebb and flow of time and a reminder that nothing is forever. It connects us and gives meaning. It's joy and pain. Life is unpredictable, but essential.
I am your health partner for life.
For life.
For life.
For life.
HMG is your health partner for life.
How can I help you?
Hey, you're still open.
Yes, we are here Monday through Saturday, 7 a.m. to 7 p.m.
That is really convenient.
With Drive-Thru Plus, our interactive teller machines, you have access to traditional banking services during non-traditional times, all from your car. Bank of Tennessee and Carter County Bank. Solutions made simple.
It's never been a better time to buy at Friendship Hyundai. New 2022 Sun for only $169 a month or 0% for 72 months on all 2020 Santa Fe, Sonata, and Tucson. Nobody beats Friendship Hyundai of Bristol and Johnson City. We're dealing.
Toyota's Friday Night Rivals, driven by your local Toyota dealer.
It is a full moon night in Carter County. And right now, Happy Valley needs some full moon magic. Second down and 10 to the air.
This.
Oh, it's a double flanker throw. And Babb is out there. He's open. He's to the 30. No one is going to run down Matthew Babb. And Happy Valley is right back in this game. What a play.
A little trickery to start the fourth quarter for Happy Valley. That was a wide receiver throwback. Andrew Little throws a touchdown pass to Matthew Vaughn, and you could just see that formation. Something was up. We do have a South Greene player down. But take a look here at the replay. Ayers throws it back to Little, and Little to Vaughn.
A strike. He throws a strike, too. Phillips tries to run him down, but you're not going to catch Matthew Vaughn.
That's a 70-yard touchdown, but we do have an injured, again, South Greene player down about the 45-yard line.
Oh, Well, I've been thinking about your trivia question. And I'll give you the results of my research right after this break. You're watching Toyota Friday Night Rivals.
Friendship Ford is your Ford truck headquarters. Drive a new Escape for $199 a month or get up to $15,000 off new F-150, all with an Any Reason 3-Day Exchange, a free lifetime warranty, and a $5,000 best price guarantee. Nobody beats Friendship Ford of Bristol. We're dealing.
There's a spirit that you'll experience in the mountains of Virginia when you're part of Emory and Henry College, a place of connections and quality. With more than 80 majors and tracks in undergraduate, like pre-health and engineering science, a new school of business, and master's and doctoral degrees at the School of Health Sciences, you can excel at Emory and Henry. The new Career Center offers free student and alumni support for interview experience, internships, job searches, and more. Be part of a winning experience at Emory and Henry College, a place of connections and spirit.
Warren Heating and Cooling, the comfort experts. The temperatures are hot with high humidity. Warren Heating and Cooling invites your call now. We'll install a system to fit your needs and provide you top service. Carrier, turn to the experts with Warren Heating and Cooling.
With early voting underway, stay with News 5 for coverage of the key races and issues that affect you as November 3rd approaches. Then on Election Day, get up-to-the-minute results on News 5 WCYB, Facebook Live, and WCYB.com.
The amazing display of fall colors is beautiful this time of year, but these same leaves can also present a hazard. As leaves fall on highways, they can create slick, dangerous conditions, especially when wet. Slow down and avoid accidents when driving on leaf-covered roads.
The birds and the boys.
This rivalry is real.
If you thought this game couldn't get any more heated, we'll see you Sunday night. Cowboys, Eagles, Sunday Night Football on NBC.
Well, there are injuries, and there are injuries to your best player. This is Luke Myers they've been attending to, having to limp off the field. It appeared to be a cramp, Casey. Let's take a check of his performance so far up to this point.
I mean, he's done everything offensively for South Greene. Some big runs. Look at this, just running over defenders. He's been all over the field. This is a long touchdown run here. That made it 14-6. Myers have a heck of a night here, so he's going to have to come out at least for one play here defensively. I mean, this is just the extra point now for Happy Valley after that 70-yard touchdown, but certainly keep an eye on Luke Myers, see if he'll be able to come in here once South Greene goes on offense.
See what Happy Valley does this time, because last time they went for two.
Looks like they're going to go for two again.
It appears they're going for two again. And now one of the linemen says, hey, what am I doing? Ball is loose and no good, so extra point is no good. South Greene still leads it 28-20. You're watching Friday Night Rivals, powered by your local Toyota dealers.
1, 2, 3,
during the Today's the Day event, lease this 2020 Camry LE for $199 a month, or get the last of the 2020 Camrys with 0 for 60 financing, or get up to $3,000 customer cash. Toyota, let's go places.
For 85 years, Citizens Bank has focused on you, the local people and businesses in the communities we serve. Locally owned, the bank makes decisions here, not in Nashville, New York, or Atlanta. We support our communities. Citizens Bank Stadium is one of the many projects we're proud of, in person or online at citizensbank24.com.
At Citizens Bank, supporting our neighbors and businesses and their successes is a priority, and it will continue to be a priority in the future.
Here's to 85 more years helping you with your financial needs.
Turns out we've got a pretty good ball game after all, 28-20 with plenty of time left. But the big question is the health of Luke Myers. Two plays ago, we watched him limp off the field. He looked like he was in a lot of pain. And now you see Myers on the sidelines talking to his coaches. What do you think, Casey?
Oh, he's right there at the front of the line. He looks like somebody that's going to go back in the game. He has his helmet on.
Babb getting ready for the Toyota kickoff. I mean, Bond is getting ready for the Toyota kickoff. comes South Greene. Up the left sidelines and out of bounds. Great return there by Clint Lamb.
All right, so you ready to give me some answers here?
Okay, I've been thinking about it. I think Elizabethan.
Nope.
Nope? They lost it. They're not going to be 10-0?
They didn't play 10 games. Union County.
Remember, Union. Forget about that. Okay, David Crockett?
Nope. Cherokee. They didn't play Cherokee.
Cherokee. Boy, I'm a dope. South Greene.
Yes, South Greene is one of them, yes.
Man, it's tougher than I thought. I thought sure it was Betsy. I forgot all about the Union County game. Well, I know all of Carter County is wiped out, all the county schools, because they all lost a game early. Here you get a handoff.
It's Crum.
That is Crum, and Myers is in the game, so he's apparently okay.
Got a late flag coming in after that play. Yeah, Myers, it'll be interesting to see if he runs the ball at all here, if he's going to just be more of getting it to the other playmakers, and maybe this is more Mark Crum time for the rest of the game here. There is a flag.
Is Volunteer one of the games?
Volunteer is one of them.
Okay, that was my backup pick, so I've got two.
The result of the play was a first down. After the play, personal foul, defense number 3, 15-yard penalty.
That's the, they said a personal foul after the play on number 3. That's Andrew Little. That's his second personal foul.
Didn't see a whole lot there. It looked like Little just stood up.
Yeah.
Not sure if they issued that to the wrong number or what exactly.
Either way, South Greene now inside the 20-yard line.
Back in the Toyota red zone. Myers handing to Crum, getting the push from Ayers again. All right, you can't leave us anymore. What's the third one?
Cloudland.
Oh, it is Cloudland. Even though the Carter County schools, they must have made it up.
They made it up. Yeah, Cloudland and Volunteer, neither one of them played the first week of the season, but they made up a game during their bye week. South Greene, the only team that had no changes to their schedule. They played every game.
Like it was supposed to be. What a crazy year. Great trivia question by Casey Getz, and all you folks that texted me, you were all wrong. Myers, it's deflected off the receiver's hands. Incomplete.
Matthew Bond made that big hit there on Myers just as he was getting ready to throw it here. Watch number 22 coming from the backside. You're going to see him eventually coming to your screen. Bond just never gives up. He ran by one of his teammates there to make that first contact with Myers.
It looked like Caleb Robinson was wide open there early, and he didn't throw it to him. Nevertheless, third down and 7 now. Happy Valley trying to keep South Greene out of the end zone.
That was the most he ran on that play action there.
Inside handoff. That's Hauser getting tripped up. But I think he may have enough for the first down.
Oh, it has a really nice play. A counter to Hauser.
Hauser took a good shot.
Yeah.
Got to pull his pants up there for television. Thank you.
Yeah, they ran a counter back to Hauser. And they're going to measure this one. Hauser's shaking up a little bit there. So it was a 3rd and 7. That was the first time we've seen South Greene run that counter back to the short side of the field.
Hauser's going to take a deep breath and walk it off.
If it is short, it'll be 4th and less than a yard.
I should have known that trivia question when I said all of Carter County was knocked out. You had that glint in your eye. I should have, wait a minute. What about Cloudland?
I almost didn't think of Cloudland. I had to go back and look at it twice there. The first time I was looking through it, I missed them and went back. I was like, they did make up the Happy Valley game.
What did Hampton lose? What game?
They lost Gallenberg-Pittman.
Gallenberg-Pittman, that's right.
They didn't even measure. It's going to be 4th and 1 here. Certainly, I would expect South Greene to go for this here.
Oh, wow. I thought he had that. They did mark him short.
See, Myers has not run it since he's left the game with an injury, but if he's going to be under center here, maybe just push right forward here and try and pick up the yard.
That's what he's going to do. And he's going to get that and more. Those legs are turning. There's nothing wrong with those legs as he turns his way for a Luke Myers touchdown, as only Luke Myers can do it.
There was a flag that just got thrown there. There was a couple of linemen that were locked well after the play there. I don't know if they're going to say that was after the play. I think it's going to be against Happy Valley, the way they just look like they talked to Coach Jones.
Throw the play was a touchdown. After the play, personal foul. Defense number 43 will be assessed on the kickoff.
So the news goes from bad to worse for Happy Valley. Look at Myers. This is great second effort. Remember, he's dealing with a calf injury where he had a cramp. But look at that. Just powers his way into the end zone. Higgins is off the extra point. And it's good.
Now they're going to assess that penalty on the kickoff. So South Greene will be kicking this one off.
As we see him power his way in the end zone, let's power our way to the Toyota Spotlight.
Tonight's school spotlight is brought to you by your local Toyota dealer.
Susan Burns says teaching was a calling. Both of her parents were teachers, and now she's coming up on 30 years. 23 of those have been at Happy Valley.
I started with a passion for wanting to teach at a very young age. I taught my dolls and stuffed animals.
She teaches Spanish, geometry, and ACT prep for English. That's in addition to being the chess coach and working with the after-school program. It may sound like those subjects are vastly different, but Burns says they have more in common than you might think.
Geometry is, math and lots of formulas, and Spanish is very formulated. Chess is very strategic. I love puzzles, and so just putting things together, to me, it's a big game, and I like to make it a game with my students.
It's her students that she says keeps her motivated after nearly three decades in education.
The best thing about teaching is the light bulb effect. Seeing a student finally understand what I'm saying, and it's just the look on their faces. They go, oh, I get it. And that's the moment that makes it all worthwhile.
There's a great look at him, taking some tape off his helmet, probably from the opposing team. Luke Myers fighting off a calf injury. Had a horrible cramp, had to leave the game, but it comes back to lead South Greene back to the end zone, and Myers takes it in on individual effort.
In fact, I don't know other parts of the state, but I will be shocked if he is not a semifinalist for Mr. Football. I mean, how that works is they name five semifinalists and they narrow it down to three finalists. I mean, what he's done, I will be stunned if he's not a semifinalist, and he really should be a finalist for Mr. Football. So we'll see how that goes. But South Greene, with that penalty, they're going to kick this ball off from the 45-yard line now, so they could do an onside kick if they wanted to, or maybe try and do a pooch kick and pin Happy Valley deep.
He is trying to boot it away, and that is going to go into the end zone. So Happy Valley will start it from the 20. Of course, in high school football, you can't run it out of the end zone. That is the rule.
Some updated stats on Myers. He's 162 yards rushing on just 12 carries. I mean, averaging 13 and a half yards a carry.
He's accounted for every touchdown, hasn't he? Except for the one to Crum.
Where he pushed, kind of helped Crum get in there. So four and a half touchdowns, yeah.
Three and a half. We got a little second here. You've also got some scores of interest, too. Science Hill tonight found itself with a chance to avoid Maryville, but that did not happen.
Now, Science Hill could have been the one seed if they went to Bearden and won, but they lost 27-7. So now Dobbins-Bennett is the one seed, so a big win for the Indians, even though they didn't play tonight.
Here comes Matthew Babb with nowhere to go, but somehow he makes a place. He was about a foothold away from breaking that.
Yeah, Matthew Bond there for Happy Valley. Nice effort there, but South Greene, certainly you're getting to the point now, you're Happy Valley, you're down by 15, 9.5 minutes to go. You can stay with what you do, but you need to maybe start having a little more pace with how you're going to get to the line of scrimmage quickly. mean, certainly they did have that 70-yard touchdown, but now they kind of use that play, and South Greene will be ready if they try and run that trick again here. What else do they have available in their arsenal here with 9 minutes to go?
They got a lot of folks spread out now. Ayers from the shotgun is going to put it to the air. Plenty of time to throw. Now he's going to roll to his right. He's going to throw it over the middle, and that's incomplete.
He's looking for Little, who was trying to come back to the ball, but Ayers could not get it to him. So third and nine, and where Happy Valley is certainly, you know, this is not four down territory when you're at your own 21-yard line. So if they don't pick up this first down, you know, unless they're like a yard away or something, they're probably going to have to punt it here and hope their defense can get a stop. But
third and nine from their own 20. From the shotgun. Screen play. There is some yardage there, but it's not going to be enough. Maybe it is. Depends on where he landed. That was
Gabe Nichols. Yeah, I think he did have enough for a first down. They are going to move the sticks there. He went airborne. Little wide receiver screen here. Did a good job just to catch it as well, and almost got tackled there and goes airborne and gets past the 30-yard line. Just by a yard, he got the first down.
Just by a flip. Flipped enough for the first down. That keeps the drive alive. Happy Valley first and 10 now from the 30, just past the 30, actually. Fake handoff to the air. Again, that was Little spinning. Little appears to have twisted something when he spun there. Not the best frame of mind, as it looked like he was in obvious pain there on the sidelines. Maybe his ankle right there when he twisted. Three guys not getting down. Of course, that doesn't feel very good either.
He is staying in the game here, so maybe just wanted to catch his breath for half a second there. He did get out of bounds, so that stops the clock. Again, because Hampton won tonight, win or lose now, Happy Valley will be starting the playoffs on the road next week.
Ayers taking that handoff and going up the middle, but it's no go. South Greene was waiting for him. See the replay there. Linebackers are just waiting for him.
Phillip Blair.
So it's a familiar spot.
We got Happy Valley taking the timeout here. So down by 15, it's third and four. These timeouts are valuable when you're down here, but now it'll be time for our drive of the game.
It certainly is. Let's cue it up. The Toyota drive of the game, and it starts here.
Starts with a kickoff return. Jalen Ingram with a nice return for South Greene. This is back in the second quarter. Luke Myers, a designed run here. This is when he runs over Little there. And then Myers going to hand it off to Crum and kind of show him the way. And then another designed run all the way for Myers. He takes this one into the end zone. That made it 14-6. South Greene, that is your Toyota driving the game.
Otherwise known as the Luke Myers driving the game.
So Happy Valley burning the timeout here. Pivotal play on third and four, just under 8 minutes to go. You're down by 15. Now, since they got the ball close to the 40, I believe that they would be in four down territory here.
Of course, when you talk about this division, Meigs County is the power, I think, that everybody thinks is maybe the best team in the state in that division.
They've been the roadblock for these teams out of Region 1 for the last couple of years.
Inside handoff. Some running room. That's that big fullback, Landon Babb, getting some good yardage. And another Toyota first down.
All right, so they get the first down. The clock winding again as we approach 7.5 minutes. And Happy Valley needs two touchdowns. And they'll have to go for two at least one of the times.
Nichols split out to the left. Ayers is rolling that way. He's going to throw it out for him. Nichols is out there. He's trying to come back for the ball and cannot. And so there's a flag on the play. It looked like the defense was all over him.
Yeah, but you know what? At high school level, that's a good play. It's only a 15-yard penalty. So if you get beat, I mean, Bailey did not look back for the ball. Preston Bailey of South Greene. Nichols was trying to fight the turnaround. So it'll be 15 yards, but a 15-yard penalty is a lot better than a 40-yard catch. You see Bailey never turned around.
Harris could have put a little more air under that ball. He could have been gone. Nichols had a step on the defense, no doubt about it. From the 40. Happy Valley desperately trying to get back in this game. Ayers hands to Babb. Gets to the corner. Eats up that yardage. He gets about 10 on that run. He's close to another first down.
Nice run there by Bond, and he gets out of bounds. Every second important for Happy Valley when they're down by 15. So he gets out of bounds, and he does pick up a first down. Matthew Bond having a stellar performance.
He really is fun to watch.
He really is. Yeah, obviously, our first chance to see him in person this year.
He's like a wind-up toy. You just wind him up and watch him go. That's Bond in the backfield. It's Ayers keeping it. He's got some running room before he's upended there by a good tackle by Lamb. Clock continues to tick. Almost 6 minutes left here in the game. Happy Valley needs some mojo very quickly. Pass play. Nichols. It looked like he picked that up on the bounce.
That looked like it hit the ground to me.
Yeah. It looked like a shortstop, but the official behind him did not indicate hit the ground.
It absolutely did hit the ground, but Nichols, what he did was he went with it. I mean, the referee looked like he was right going to blow the whistle, and he did it.
And he did. So they got a little bonus there.
Happy Valley hurrying up. They don't have to worry about them stopping it to look at the replay.
There is no replay. Yeah. Yeah. We've got the only replay that doesn't count. So that's Little getting it close.
I think he's a little shaken up.
We've talked about Little speed tonight. They need a lot of Little speed right now. 5 minutes, 28 seconds. Player down. All right, so we've got a time to check out Matthew Bond. We've talked about him. Let's show you his talent. Casey, take it away.
Oh, he's done a little bit of everything tonight there. I knew he was fast before, but what impressed me more was his vision today. He always seems like he's in the right place. And, of course, this one, he was a receiver. And you saw Myers fall down. That's when he was injured as well. But I don't think even if he didn't fall down, he wasn't going to catch Matthew Bond.
You know, talking to some of the Happy Valley coaches before the game, you know, they said, you know, this kid's only played 3 years of football. He came here as a new student and was just terrific. And he played soccer growing up. So when you play soccer, totally different from football. I mean, there's some similarities, of course. But he's adapted the game so well. And as we've often said, he's probably the best running back in the entire district.
Yeah, and, you know, Coach Jones for South Greene said that, is that, you know, he is the best back. I mean, obviously, there are two stud quarterbacks in this region with Luke Myers and then Connor Jones at Hampton. Bond, 118 yards, 26 carries. And, you know, we said back in the first quarter, said he's ready for a 30-carry game. He's almost there.
Yeah, he's almost there. He'll probably get it before the night's over. Happy Valley again knocking on the door, first down and 10. Good fake by Ayers. Now he's going to roll out, put some air under it, throws it up in the end zone. He's got a receiver out there, but it's incomplete, and he's into the fence.
Yeah, really close to the fence there. Hopefully he's okay.
Wow.
Good sportsmanship there by Ingram helping him up.
Oh, he is. He's stunned. I mean, he hit that fence pretty hard. I'm sure he's not the first player in Happy Valley history to hit that fence. It is pretty close. We showed you a shot from the drone earlier about how tight it is on that sideline. Look at this replay again as Ayers puts some air under this ball. But
it's Alex Lunsford.
Oh, man. He tried to keep his feet in. By doing that, it allowed his motion to continue. That's why he crashed into the fence. Hopefully he's okay.
Good sportsmanship there by Jalen Ingram to help him up.
There he is. Yeah, the officials blowing the whistle.
We've got another timeout, this one for Happy Valley again. So now they've already used two timeouts here.
So it's 35-20, but Happy Valley is threatening. You're watching Friday Night Rivals, powered by your local Toyota dealers.
With early voting underway, stay with News 5 for coverage of the key races and issues that affect you as November 3rd approaches. Then on Election Day, get up-to-the-minute results on News 5 WCYB, Facebook Live, and WCYB.com.
The amazing display of fall colors is beautiful this time of year, but these same leaves can also present a hazard. As leaves fall on highways, they can create slick, dangerous conditions, especially when wet. Slow down and avoid accidents when driving on leaf-covered roads.
The birds and the boys.
This rivalry is real.
If you thought this game couldn't get any more heated, we'll see you Sunday night. Cowboys, Eagles, Sunday Night Football on NBC.
What has Happy Valley got up their sleeve? They need something right now, down by 15, but they are threatening. Second down and 10.
They've had to burn two timeouts on this drive offensively.
Pitch play, Matthew Bond going to take it up the middle, but he is corralled by that South Greene defense.
That was his 27th carry of the game. Some other scores rolling in tonight. PJ Greenville beat Sullivan East 68-14. And David Crockett, they won their eighth game in a row. They went 42-30 at Morristown East.
And you learned about a special game that's going to happen next Thursday, right?
Well, I saw it on Twitter. I haven't seen any confirmation yet, but our good buddy Steve Wilmoth did tweet out earlier today that Sullivan East and Sullivan Central were going to play next week, and neither team going to the playoffs. They were supposed to play during the regular season, but they were unable to, so that would be cool if they could both play next week.
That would be nice. Case will keep you informed on that. Ayers drops back to throw over the middle, and it's caught. Great catch by Little over the middle. That might have been Ayers' best throw of the night.
I agree. That was a great throw by Ayers. Right down the seam here.
I mean, this is a bullet. And Little hauls it in over two defenders. Now, what does Happy Valley do? Do they go for two here? They're going to have to at some point.
They are. I mean, I'm always a believer you want to be a one-possession game as long as possible here, you know, but they have only attempted one extra point tonight, and they didn't get it, so they're going to go for two here. If they don't get this, they're going to have to still score two more times.
Ayers to the air. It is complete, and it's Little again. Wow. Happy Valley says, take that.
Again, here's the best throw of the night from Ayers. To Little, and all of a sudden we got a 7-point game.
Wow, we've got a 7-point game, and we've got more coming up. Stay with us.
For the replay, watching like Superman lay out for that one. What a catch by Parker Hughes.
Good throw by Fox. Fox to Taylor. Watch him turn that back. And it's a double reverse. Here comes Ingram up the right sidelines. He's got some space, and there he goes. Going to be a little trick play. It's going to be Bridges throwing back to Thompson. He's open, and he's got it for a touchdown. That dude was way too excited talking about those football plays. Great job by our crew of Pac-Man Productions. Tim Petrie, our director, put all that together for us. What a great season we've had, and it's all because of you guys, the hard work that you've done. All we do is talk about it, and we've got a good one to talk about tonight. It's 35-28. This game a lot closer than a lot of folks thought it would be. South Greene has rolled through almost everybody this year. They're undefeated, but Happy Valley giving them a fight right down to the end.
4:11 left. Now, Happy Valley only has one timeout left. They did have to burn two timeouts. So do you onside kick it here? Certainly, South Greene is anticipating that. They have 10 guys within 20 yards of where the ball is currently, only one person back.
Matthew Bond just barely kicks it.
That was touched by a Happy Valley player after about 2 yards, so that's a legal touch.
Illegal touch.
On the kicking team, 5-yard penalty, re-kick.
You know, for a soccer player, it was a very good kick by Matthew. I have to get on him about that. He almost missed the ball. I think he tried to kick it so lightly, he almost missed the ball.
They actually called offside, so it wasn't the was not the best kick, but they were offside before that, so now they have to do it again.
All right, here's the secret play we're going to run now, Matthew.
That last Happy Valley drive, 11 plays, 80 yards, took 5.5 minutes off the clock.
Wow. Bond puts a little bit better foot into this one. South Green's going to get good field position. Look who it is. That's right. It's that quarterback. Luke Myers fielded that kick and made the nice return.
4:04 to go. You mentioned, PJ, great field position for South Green. Happy Valley, just one timeout. So realistically, I mean, South Green is probably 2 first downs away from ending this game.
I think we're going to get a dose of Luke Myers here in the next couple of minutes. You put the ball in the hands of your best player, don't you?
You do. I mean, let him make the decision to walk in that read option there. You know, if he wants to give it to Crum, he'll do that. Whatever. He's done a good job reading the play tonight and giving what the doing what the defense gives him.
It is Crum. Crum's got a huge hole. He's breaking back to the right side for a first down. Another Toyota first down for South Green.
So they get one first down here, and the play clock is already going. They'll start the game clock once the ball is spotted. As Crum with a nice run here. So now, you know, Myers, quarterback, he's crafty enough to know he's going to be looking at that play clock, or at least he should be, and not snapping the ball until it gets to about 5 seconds.
Myers lets it tick down. High snap, but Myers going to keep it. He follows Crum into the line.
They picked up about 6 yards there on first down.
That's happened a couple times tonight where Myers has had to reach up for the snap. So far, he's been flawless about it, though.
Jason Jarrett, his defense really needs to stop.
They need to stop. They need a turnover. They need the ball back. They're down 35-28.
The play clock's at 15 right now. Game clock approaching 3 minutes.
What an entertaining ball game as we end up our coverage of Friday Night Rivals with a terrific showdown here in Carter County. Myers to Crum. Crum falls down. Of course, he got some help.
We got an injured player for Happy Valley.
I think that might be Bond.
Yeah, that is Matthew Bond.
Bond took a shot in the knee when he kind of tripped up the running back, Crum.
Got a, looks like Happy Valley called their final timeout with the referees motion. There was a couple of linemen that were playing well through the whistle on that last play. Both sides were saying it should be a flag on the other, of course. Hopefully Matthew Bond.
You know, I'm going to sound like Grandpa Johnson here, but back in the day, you know, kids were used to playing both ways. When I played high school football, I played almost every play, as did everybody else. Now, you know, you get kids like this, when you play, think of how exhausted Matthew Bond is, because he's in this double-A level where you have to play a lot. He takes a hard hit like this. And
see, 22 kind of sticks his leg out there. And
he holds the back of his leg immediately after helping make that tackle. You got to imagine a lot of these programs where you have to double up. You're going to be tired. You're going to get injured. Bond taking his helmet off. He's kind of sitting up now. You help him up. Can't put a whole lot of weight on that leg.
Great to see him up and going off on his own power.
We watched him earlier at senior night get a rose and a walkout.
He's had a heck of a game, and he has at least, you know, hopefully, I guess you can never say in 2020, but hopefully, you know, they will be in the playoffs next week and everything will be okay, hopefully, for him. And, you know, with COVID, you never know.
You know, I'm glad you brought that up, because we talked to Sean Jones. He says it's everyone's fear that you get COVID now, because if you do now, you're done for the playoffs, because it's a two-week minimum, right? So hopefully everybody will stay healthy and smart.
Okay, so they did not, the referee didn't, I think it must have been an injury timeout, so the clock is winding. Happy Valley still has their one timeout here, third and five.
Third and five. Luke Myers from the shotgun.
If Myers, the play clock's at 20, should not be snapping this now.
Myers keeps it. He's just finding his way. Man, look at him fight.
I mean, they had contact behind the first down marker, but he picked the first down.
Well, he just drug a couple of defenders with him. He just refused to go down. He gets a Toyota first down, and that might be the end of the line for Happy Valley. 2 minutes, 15 seconds, and ticking.
Yeah, Myers, they snapped that ball with 20 seconds on the play clock, and if he would have gotten tackled right there, I mean, he was a couple yards short of the first down marker there. I mean, that was a heck of a play by Myers.
I'll have to ask Sean Jones what this kid can leg press. I bet it's like 400 pounds or something.
See, coach is fired up there. Play clock's down at five. He may have to call a timeout here.
They've got enough time if he snaps it now, and they do. That's Crum. Crum's got a hole. He's going to cut back on the middle. He's going to be close to another first down. There's another Toyota first down.
There's a first down.
Look at Crum, man. What a hole.
South Greene, they have. So the clock should be rolling here. There's no reason why South Greene should be snapping this ball. Play clock's at 13.
Man in motion. Just going to ride the fullback. Myers driven backwards for one of the few times tonight.
Man, that ball was almost close to being knocked out. Timmy Mounts was there. You heard the people screaming, go for the ball. I mean, watch, the ball is kind of just hanging out there almost.
Oh, boy, look at that. Oh, great shot by our camera guys. But he did not lose it. Sometimes that's when you fumble, when you're fighting for that extra yardage. You put all your effort into your legs, and you forget about your arms. And you're holding on to the ball sometime too tight and squeeze it out.
Yeah, we're under a minute left. Clock is winding down. I think South Greene is going to just take a timeout when the play clock gets down to one. As you can see, it's on the screen now. It's 6 seconds.
Yeah. There goes Sean Jones with that timeout. You got to get the ball.
Timeout, South Greene.
So it's second down. They can almost down it and run this thing out, huh?
Yeah, I mean, Happy Valley
only has trying to score.
Happy Valley only has one timeout, so they could take a knee, and if Happy Valley calls a timeout, take another knee, game's over.
What a fight tonight by the Warriors coming back. South Greene, though, has so many talented offensive options.
Got to give a shout-out while we have it. You mentioned our crew earlier. Going to give them all a shout-out here. They've done an amazing job all year. Got Jim Martin, Ian Petrie, Scotty Liston, Preston Cox, Scott Ripple, all in the cameras. Chris Smith, replay. Replay's been unbelievable all year. Alex Martin on audio. Jeremiah Royston on the parabolic mic. Got Brian Siegelong, engineer. Tim Doyle, AJ LaPerge, video assist. Steve Honaker, our Red Hat's done a great job all year. Leonard Cox, producer. Patrick Ball on the graphics. And, of course, Tim Petrie, our director. Yeah. Great crew. Thank you, guys.
Just the best crew we've ever worked with. This is our third year of Friday Night Rivals, and it has been so much fun for us this year.
All right, looks like they are in victory formation here. I think that was probably conveyed during that timeout that there's no need for us to try and run the ball here, take a knee, and make Happy Valley use their timeout, and then take another knee and wrap up a 10-0 regular season for the Rebels.
A lot of respect between these two programs. South Greene knew this was not going to be an easy game. You just don't come to the hill and think you're going to run over the Warriors. The victory formation. Myers takes it, puts the knee down. Now Jarrett stops it with the final timeout.
So now it's third down, but again, all they need to do is take a knee. There's a
There's no way to stop the clock after that.
Got another final. Unicoi County beating Johnson County tonight, 24-20.
Wow.
That's a big win for the Blue Devils.
Was
we saw
in,
them
was
last
that
week.
Was that in Mountain City?
No, it was
in Irwin.
Yep.
Well, we had such a good time in Irwin the last, when we were, was that last week?
Last week, yeah.
Yeah. This season is just one big COVID nightmare. Can't remember what I did last week. They were terrific to work with over in Unicoi County. So congratulations to the boys from Irwin as they fight for a spot in the playoffs. But unfortunately, they'll end up playing what?
Oh, well, then now that was a big, they got the third seed, and that means Johnson County now has to go play Alcoa in the first round. And so Myers takes a knee there on third down. The play clock was never reset. Now it is. So now the game is over. They don't need to run a play. And
South Greene realizes that, and now Happy Valley realizes as well. And Sean is just telling his kids, hey.
You see the guys holding their hands up on South Greene. They're holding up five fingers on 10-0.
They 10-0.
Undefeated. Congratulations to the Rebels. That's worth a round of applause from the crowd here. I mean, that is special. You go undefeated in high school football. That is hard to do. Only two teams in our area did. Elizabethan did as well. They won big tonight over Sullivan Central. So just two teams go undefeated, and it's really special. Congratulations to South Greene.
35-28 is your final. Of course, we'll be talking to the victorious coach of the South Greene Rebs. And that, of course, is Sean Jones. And we'll be back with the interview with Sean Jones. 35-28, South Greene finishes the season undefeated.
Friendship Ford is your Ford truck headquarters. Drive a new Escape for $199 a month or get up to $15,000 off new F-150. All with an any reason 3-day exchange, a free lifetime warranty, and a $5,000 best price guarantee. Nobody beats Friendship Ford of Bristol. We're dealing.
Such a simple word, but a not so simple thing. Life is beautiful, but fragile. It's the ebb and flow of time and a reminder that nothing is forever. It connects us and gives meaning. It's joy and pain. Life is unpredictable, but essential.
I am your health partner for life.
For life.
For life.
For life.
HMG is your health partner for life.
Here at East Coast Wings and Grill, we value the communities we serve and appreciate the opportunity to be good stewards, especially during this challenging time. That's why we're proud to support high school sports as a Friday Night Rivals sponsor. Our employees are going the extra mile to ensure that our food is prepared and packaged in the cleanest possible environment. And as always, we offer delivery options with DoorDash and Easy Cater. Call or visit online to place your takeout order today. That's East Coast Wings and Grill, Kingsport and Johnson City.
At Friendship Ram in Bristol. 0% for 72 months or 20% off MSRP on select new Ram 1500s and get our $5,000 best price guarantee. Nobody can beat Friendship Ram in Bristol. We're dealing.
So it's a final. South Greene finishes the regular season undefeated 35-28 over Happy Valley. And we're glad to be joined now by Coach Sean Jones of the South Greene Rebels. Whoa, yeah, we got to quit meeting like this, Coach, because you're getting used to winning on our TV games. Congratulations.
Well, thanks, guys. You know, it was a hard-fought game. We knew it was going to be hard-fought with Happy Valley. They got a great team. Hats off to them. You know, we just sucked it up right there and got to win when we needed to at the end.
Coach, all your players holding up 10 fingers behind you there, 10-0. Describe to us, how hard is it to go undefeated in high school football?
Oh, it's extremely hard. You know, when the season starts, you got games and you got the non-conference games, and you don't know how tough they're going to be from year in to year out. And it's just, you know, it's just tough to do this, especially in high school football. And we're glad to be one of the top two teams that's undefeated here in East Tennessee. Oh, yeah.
Coach, did your heart stop when Luke Myers went down with what looked like a leg injury, even though he was able to to come back for a second there? Were you scared?
Well, just for a little bit. When we ran, I don't know if you saw me. I went sprinting out there, and he said it was a cramp. So that's why, we acted that way. But, you know, number one makes us go. You don't know that. You've seen us all year, and we just put it on his shoulders. And even Mark Crum. I want to big shout out to Mark Crum tonight, because last couple of weeks we've thrown the ball, and he hadn't been a big part of the game, and tonight he was.
Coach, now, how do you tell your team, you go 10-0, but now it's a whole new season starting next week. How do you refocus the guys and say, hey, 0-0, and get this going for the playoffs?
I mean, that's just what we do. You know, we just tell them, you know, we've got a new season next week. You know, we think we got Cumming Gap, got them at South Greene, and, you know, we're just going to see what happens. You know, we're looking at least 12 wins, what we're looking at to get a school record, and, you know, we got dreams in front of us, and that's what we're going to try to do.
Well, Coach, we appreciate you joining us tonight. It was a terrific show that you put on, and why don't you give that trophy to your kids? I think they deserve it.
Before I do, I got one shout out. My wife said if I didn't shout out to her tonight, I was going to sleep by myself, so I just want to give her a shout out tonight. So thanks for her letting me do this, and something I love. But thank you guys. Here you go, fellas. Here you go.
Yeah. All right, Mrs. Jones, I hope you forgive your husband. You did get this shout out. Well, we've had a terrific season. We've got so many folks to thank. Toyota, Hosted Medical Group, Friendship Ford, Food City, Northeast State Community College, Citizens Bank, East Coast Wings and Grill, the Bank of Tennessee, the wonderful folks here at Happy Valley that made us feel at home. A special thanks to Tim Petrie, our director in Pac-Man Productions, the best in the business. As the moon sets tonight for Casey Getz, this is PJ Johnson. Thanks to all the folks back at the big station, WCYB, for all your support as well. We'll see you again next season on Friday Night Rivals.